following is a special presentation of ESPN on ABC.
The new horseshoe in the banks of the Brazos. Blacked out tonight as the unbeaten Baylor Bears collide with Oklahoma. Saturday Night Football on ABC, presented by Walmart. An energized McLean Stadium. Two playoff contenders with two options, victory or virtual elimination. Buckle up for a wild one in Waco tonight. We expect high tempo, high scoring, and of course, high stakes. Chris Fowler, Kirk Herbstreit, ready, partner? Catch your breath. This is going to be blasting off the starting line in about 13 minutes from now. High stakes because Baylor's sitting number six in the selection committee rankings. They feel a little disrespected, misunderstood by the committee. The schedule so far has been pretty weak, but the stretch run is very, very demanding. And Art Briles believes if they win out, they are in. But Oklahoma thinks they're in the hunt, too, if they win out.
Yeah, Oklahoma is a team that's looking at redemption probably more than anything else, especially against Baylor. I don't think they're worried necessarily at this point about their resume, but you're right about Baylor. I think Baylor's a team that was frustrated a year ago with the committee, and now they're looking at their season, and everything is in front of them. They feel if they can win out, they're going to have a very strong case. But tonight is that first real big hurdle against Bob Stoops and the Sooners.
Stoops calls Art Briles a genius. He used that word describing the offense. The Bears play faster than anybody, score more than anybody, gain more yards than anybody, and they're surrounded by playmakers.
And I think they stress you as a defense more than anybody, and it's because it starts really with their formations. And we'll talk throughout the broadcast how they do that, but they'll stretch you from sideline to sideline literally, and they make you basically make a choice on what you want to try to stop. They're very confident in Chalk Linwood. As an offense, they're going over 300 yards a game on the ground, and if you get too concerned about what they can do in their running game, they're going to find one-on-one matchups and look for Coleman on the outside to try to create favorable matchups. This is an offense you've heard Bob and Mike Stoops talk about all week. It's all about stopping one-on-one matchups. Now, Jared Stidham is a true freshman. He's going to make his second start. He looked great in his first one against Kansas State and Manhattan. Different deal tonight athletically against this Oklahoma defense.
Just turned 19, but he is very confident. They have full belief in him. Oklahoma dominated Baylor for two decades, but they've lost three out of the last four. The last two have been really embarrassing, and you use the perfect word, stressful. That's how they feel on the defensive side dealing with these Bears.
Yeah, and I think what's interesting with Mike Stoops as a defensive coordinator and with Bob as the head coach, every change that they've tried to make is about tonight, defending this offense. And it's because of the last couple years, they've given up 41 and then last year 48, where they couldn't stop them from throwing the football. They feel that they're better in the perimeter. They feel that their secondary matches up much more favorably because of the athletic ability that they have on the edge. And you're going to be seeing it. Can this secondary, led by Zach Sanchez, right there, number 15 in the middle, who's missed the last couple games with an ankle, can they hold up against Corey Coleman and the Bears' fleet-footed receivers?
They better save their energy. They're jumping around, but it takes a lot physically and mentally to face this offense. It's going to be a lot of fun in the Big 12 Conference in the next 3 weeks. It begins in a few minutes here in Baylor. And we'll see if Oklahoma can get that redemption they so desperately need as the freshman class, the Baylor line, ready to form that human tunnel from which the Bears will take the field. Baylor and Oklahoma on the banks of the Brazos tonight with a playoff spot in limbo.
Worried, how are they going to look without Seth Russell?
The true freshman did not struggle.
Oklahoma has a huge opportunity.
A game that will have significant implications on the Big 12 race.
Hey, Baylor, welcome to November. Now it's time to really play some football. You know what day it is.
Let's go. College football is chaos.
It's crazy.
Another week, another crazy play.
You fight the friction.
Be a lot of rugby going on here.
Lateral. Time's going to expire on the game.
Ball's still alive.
They got blocked.
just saw.
Fourth down at 25. He's going to fire to the sideline. Shy of the first down. He's going to lateral it back. Ball's on the ground. Picked up by Collins. Alex has got room. This game's still alive.
23 seconds left. And the receiver was out of bounds. He caught it. It's a touchdown. They ruled that he was forced out of bounds. Unbelievable. Nebraska pulls the upset.
More craziness today, and as the Bears make their entrance with the fog and the flames and the fireworks, certainly the potential for another playoff chase shaping game tonight. Bob Stoops in his 17th year used to own the Baylor Bears, but not in recent years. He's with Heather Cox.
Chris, thanks so much. Coach Stoops, with so much riding on this game, how have you helped your players understand what's at stake yet still play like they have nothing to lose?
Well, they just have to play within themselves. We practiced hard, do what we do. We don't need anything other than what we're capable of, but they're excited about it. Hopefully we can play well.
Coach, from point production to scheme to tempo, Baylor does present some challenges. What's the key defensively to stopping their attack?
Got to be great against a run game, and then you got to challenge them and make plays downfield.
Let's get to it. Thanks, Coach. Chris?
Sooners underdogs for the first time in the last 22 games. Art Briles, meanwhile, still feels like they owe Oklahoma a lot of payback for those years. And Briles never lost in this stadium. They're 10-0 McLean Stadium, and they have a long home winning streak as well, 20 in a row going back to October of 2012. Kirk, for so long, this was Oklahoma romping, and then Baylor began to turn it. That 2011 Robert Griffin touchdown pass here. They've won three out of the last four. You said the last two have been lopsided.
They have been completely lopsided. Oklahoma does not forget about that, and Baylor wants to remind them again. So there's a lot on the table here for both of these teams.
Oklahoma won the toss. Typically they might defer, not against Baylor. They want the football. They want to avoid falling behind, which everybody seems to do against this quick scoring Baylor team. Spencer Evans to boot it away for the Bears. And it will bounce into the end zone. So Baker Mayfield, the junior from just down the road in Austin, who beat out Trevor Knight for this starting job because he's been taking care of the football. You recall at Texas Tech, he was a good freshman, didn't get an offer, sat out here a year ago, Kirk, and he's been very sharp so far.
Well, he has provided energy to this offense. They've got a new offensive coordinator. Lincoln Riley comes over from East Carolina. This was the side of the ball. As much as we want to talk about how does Oklahoma stop Baylor, Bob Stoops made some adjustments on this side of the ball, and Baker Mayfield is the straw that mixes the drink. You know about the running game with Samaje Perine. Tonight, they've got to make some big plays in a passing game with Mayfield and his receivers.
There's big Perine, a 230-pounder, approaching 1,000 rushing yards this season. He's got him the first take. And muscles for about four. Kirk, let's check out the Chick-fil-A impact players.
Oklahoma has a lot of playmakers. They're going to go tempo here, just like Baylor will. Perine in the backfield along with Joe Mixon. Sterling Shepard, number three. If they get him isolated one-on-one, he's got to make big plays. You'll see Sean Oakman, number two, getting pressure. And big Andrew Billings in the middle has got to hold up against Perine in the Sooners' run game.
Second and seven. Mayfield escapes, but goes down. A sack on the blitz. Andrew Billings combining with Sean Oakman.
They get pressure off to the right, and this is a matchup you're going to see Baylor hope to be able to exploit. That is a true freshman going up against Jamal Palmer, a senior. Drew Samia, who moved into this starting lineup after the Texas game, he's done well. But remember, a true freshman in this atmosphere on the edge of that offensive line against a senior, that's a tough challenge.
Joe Mixon, the very quick freshman back to the right of Mayfield on third and 12. Bears show pressure again and bring it. Screen. Westbrook trying to escape, breaks a couple tackles, very near the line to make. They'll spot him, I believe, just short. Good effort, but it's fourth down.
You're going to see a lot of pressure. Phil Bennett, the defensive coordinator from Baylor, believes in pressure, especially if he gets you to third down, and that's exactly what they did, creating a little confusion. And on that first series, Chris, Phil Bennett is attacking the true freshman, Drew Samia, the right tackle, with pressure.
Austin Seibert, true freshman, one of the best punters in the country so far, and this is a good boot. And a fair catch made at the 20-yard line. So now, Kirk, we're going to see Jarrett Stidham and this Baylor offense that scored a touchdown every first possession this season. Only team to do it.
True freshman. You can see a great dual threat quarterback, but in this offense, really more of a thrower, especially with the injury already to Seth Russell. And he's got command of this offense. Remember, he was an early enrollee, so he was in school in January, went through winter conditioning, went through spring football. It's almost like when you get in early as a quarterback, it's like a redshirt freshman, but he is still a true freshman, and he's the key tonight, making good decisions and getting the ball out of his hands.
He's played in all eight games, but of course the road game at Kansas State, windy night, hostile environment, was his first start. So this is his first home start. And he goes right away to the top receiver, one of the best in the country, Corey Coleman. The Sooners, Jordan Thomas right there.
And that, again, that's the matchup. The receivers one-on-one against these Oklahoma defensive backs. It was an Achilles heel for the Sooners a year ago. Corey Coleman, number one, is the go-to man. He's the guy that can make so many things happen.
And now Shaq Linwood has a crease. Linwood into the secondary. Stiff arm, breaks a tackle, still running to midfield. Shaq Linwood shoved out at the 45 by Charles Tapper, but a huge play in this productive run game.
Watch the left tackle, Spencer Durango. He follows him, and then he's able to accelerate into the second level. This is what makes Linwood so good. A stiff arm to that safety, Thomas, and he goes for another 15 yards.
34-yard gain. Stidham chased, escapes, dumps it down. And Linwood is tackled at the line of scrimmage as a flag where the quarterback was hit after he dumped the ball off. Jordan Evans was tackling Stidham. Yeah. Did he do it too late?
Oh, for sure. Jordan Evans, he buried Stidham. Just buried him well after the ball was thrown.
Personal foul, roughing the passer. Defense number 26, punishing the quarterback with the weight of his body.
Oh, yeah.
15-yard penalty, first down.
I don't know if Oklahoma's trying to send a message. The ball's gone. I mean, he goes out of his way to elevate the quarterback and then bring his shoulder down. Then he's going to help him up.
That's he acted like he didn't know the ball was gone, but Reggie Smith very descriptive in that
penalty. Yeah, he was. Sure was.
Moves the ball to the 31. So Baylor threatening after just a few plays and a penalty. Linwood knocked down after a 4-yard gain. Shaq Linwood is a junior from Linden, averaging 131 a game. That's on pace to be the Baylor record.
Yeah, it's incredible. 130 and as a team. Think about this, 309 yards a game on the ground.
Now in the flat, Linwood makes the catch, knocked down a couple yards short of the marker.
You get caught up with Art Briles and his formations and the way they throw and how fast they score, and you think it's all about their passing game. They pride themselves on physicality and being able to run the ball. Over 300 yards a game on the ground, so it's not just trying to stop Corey Coleman and the receivers. You got to be able to be physical at the point of attack.
On third down, Linwood, a physical run, is wrestled down, but he gets a first down easily. DJ Ward on the tackle. Yes, the level of competition is suspect, but 6.6 per rush for this team.
Yeah, and it'll be more of a challenge tonight, but it's just, look at the formations. Look at the receivers. Look at the defensive backs aligned with the receivers. So you basically form a little box there with the defenders inside trying to stop that run.
They haven't stopped Linwood yet. That's a terrific first down gain of 8. Evans on the tackle.
It's a numbers game for the quarterback, Stidham. And, you know, he's looking over to the sideline. He's always talking, getting a feel for what he needs to do. But he's evaluating the defense and looking to see where they're committed to stop the Baylor offense. Are they committing to the run? He'll throw. Are they committing to the pass? They'll run.
Devin Chafin, number 28, gives a breather to Linwood. He's a physical back. He steps forward. It's first and goal, Baylor at the 5. Alexander on the stop, but once again, right out of the starting gates, this Bears offense is rolling.
Yeah, we talk a lot about Linwood, but you're talking about an offensive line that's played a lot of football, a lot of experience up front.
Chafin walks into the end zone, and the Bears off the mark very quickly in Waco again. 8 plays, 80 yards, 239. Most of it on the ground. All but 1 yard of it, in fact.
That was a heck of an opening drive for Shaq Linwood and the offensive line of Baylor really asserting themselves and not just scoring a touchdown, but sending a message. When you run for 65 of 66 yards on a drive to open up a game, after all the buildup and hype in this game, you're sending a message.
Snap is mishandled, and the holder, Cole Edmondson, stumbles forward. So a misfire on the extra point. That's the first one they've missed in 62 tries this year. So Baylor gets a stop and then just overpowers Oklahoma's defense to jump in front 6-0. As always, our aerial coverage provided by Goodyear. Kick off your drive with tires that return superior performance. Goodyear, more driven. Our official aerial provider on Saturday Night Football. This blacked out night, Bears in the all black uniforms off to their typical fast start. 9 for 9 touchdowns on their opening possessions. He's even FBS to do it. Alex Ross and Joe Mixon deep to receive Evans' kick. It's a line drive and it goes out of bounds. So a penalty there and the Sooners will get good starting field position. And after that opening Bears drive, some urgency all of a sudden for the Sooners.
They're going to have to. We talked earlier about Spencer Durango, the leader up front. What a great block here early in this game. Frees up Shock Linwood. Look at that stiff arm right there. And then he runs through the defensive back, Jordan Thomas. And here comes Durango again. It's the same play. What was interesting to me is Oklahoma committed one extra guy up to the line of scrimmage. The theory for Mike Stoops here is you've got one extra hat to stop the running game, and they still move 8 plays, 80 yards, and a majority of that on the ground with Shock Linwood.
And now, even though it's so early, when you face an offense like this, you better believe the opposing offense feels stress, not just the defense.
Yep.
Two-back look, Pirine and Mixon. This is Mixon slipping as he makes the cut, and he's brought down quickly. Jamal Palmer came around from the end.
Remember, this is an Oklahoma offense that made some adjustments after their Texas game. In their last 4 games, they have been much, much better, averaging 295 yards a game on the ground.
Mayfield off play action, rolls out, has room, fires near side. Sterling Shepard makes the catch. It's across the 40. As the Sooners' top receiver shows his hands, but it's still 3rd and 3.
Part of playing in this environment, like any tough environment, is you just have to weather the storm, especially against the offense that you're facing. So getting a few first downs and getting some points, very, very important if Oklahoma wants to stay in this game early.
Sooners have been a good third down team, 45% on the season. Crowd making it tough. Mayfield throws far side, catch made. Jerron Neal at midfield has a Sooner first down.
It's a heck of a throw, a long throw, but it shows you the confidence that they have in Baker Mayfield to be able to make that throw to Neal, who last week had 10 receptions. Now they're going to crank the tempo up themselves after that first down.
Downfield shot from Mayfield, overthrown. So important to connect when you have the chance. But Westbrook was covered by 2 Bears that time.
And Xavier Howard, the corner that usually plays close to the boundary, has experience, has talent. Oklahoma, you got to like the call to just try to challenge the Bear defense vertically. Sometimes even when you don't hit that, it can open some things up underneath. Just to kind of remind the Baylor secondary that you're not afraid to take some shots.
Shepard is in the slot to the right of the formation. Bears rush 4. Mayfield flushed. Cannot escape for much. Knocked down on the far sidelines by K.J. Smith, the left end. And the crowd didn't like it, but a flag comes in.
There's the emotions of Baker Mayfield that the coaches like, and at the same time, they wanted to control it. And you can see he's involved. He's not going to be a quarterback that's just going to get back and go to the next play. Lincoln Riley said he's matured in that area.
After the play, personal foul, late hit out of bounds. Defense, number 2. 15-yard penalty added to the end of the run. First down.
Well, they got Sean Oakman.
Wasn't necessarily a vicious hit, but it was just, well, out of bounds. He pulls him down. It was where he pulled him down that the penalty. There's Baker Mayfield again. He's not going to back.
Oakman's got a smile on his face.
Sure. But part of Baylor's, part of their approach to this game is, especially, they're going to bowl you, especially when you play them here in Waco.
Oakman, 6'9", 275. He knocked Trevor Knight out of the game last year with a hit as the quarterback was going to the ground. So the Sooners certainly remember that. First down after the penalty. Mayfield cannot escape. Grabbed by Trevon Blanchard. Things are getting feisty early. A helmet ripped off of Nila Casatati. The offensive lineman has got to come out.
He sure does. What a great play here by Blanchard. Watch, he's going to make this read right here. He felt he was taking Perine, so he decided to pull it and keep the ball. And then Perine obviously carries out the fake. Mayfield holds on to the ball, and Blanchard makes a play. He disguised that very well.
Empty backfield on second 13. Bears show pressure. They jumped offside. Shepard is corralled and hit for a loss. Bears are active up front. Brian Nance from his end position will check the marker. Looked like they jumped off quickly.
I think Taylor Young, the linebacker, was starting to cheat up. May have jumped as well.
Offside. Defense number one. 5-yard penalty. Repeat second down.
Reggie Smith and his crew are going to be busy tonight.
Yeah. This game has that feeling to it. I want to go back to that Baker Mayfield where he's kind of going face to face there with Sean Oakman. That's kind of been his, what he has brought to this offense, some energy. So I kind of like to see him not backing down from Baylor and stepping back up into their face a little bit.
Mayfield on second and eight, flips it to P right in the flat, gets a couple of blocks, muscles in the 25-yard line. He told me that he felt he'd been too emotional early in the season. Games against Tennessee, the loss to Texas. He was trying to sort of harness that a little bit, Kurt.
Yeah, that's Lincoln Riley's mentioned that as well, how they've been proud of how he's grown and matured in that area.
Third and short, Perine. Banging off tacklers. First down at the 15, and now the Sooners are in business in the red zone.
Boy, Perine, one of the more physical backs in college football a year ago. New offensive system with Lincoln Riley. I think the last 3 or 4 weeks we've started to see him and the passing game.
Low far side. Nowhere to run for Micaiah Quick. Short game.
Sooners offensive line starting to settle in a little bit. Starting to control that line of scrimmage on this drive and helping Baker Mayfield and especially Perine when he's had chances to run the football.
Offensive line that lost both tackles to the NFL and has two freshmen starting at tackle.
Two freshmen on the right side.
Two back look on second down and eight. This is Mixon. Stutter steps. Dives down to the six. Looks like Mixon's having trouble with his traction in the early going.
It does a little bit, but I like to see Mixon and Perine in the backfield together because I think it keeps the defense off balance and guessing a little bit. They're both versatile enough that they can block, they can run, they can catch. Keeps his Baylor defense on edge.
Perine on third and one slips again, regains his balance and scores. Looked like he might go down behind the line, but this powerful back who has great balance gives Oklahoma a chance to take the lead.
Well, he got his left hand down is why he had balance on that play. I think it's a little slick from the rain that we're having here. You're right here. He loses it, gets the left hand down, and then he runs over his own center there, Tarleton, to get into the end zone. But a big answer by the Sooners after the quick touchdown by Baylor with their first series.
Sure was. And Austin Seibert gives Oklahoma a 7-6 lead. 11 plays, 65 yards in 3:48. And Samaje Perine, his 11th rushing touchdown.
We're in the Big 12. Get ready. Touchdowns are coming. Plenty more
a lot
coming.
More, yep.
Saturday Night Football, presented by Walmart. Stop by a store or visit us at walmart.com to share wonder every day. Nissan, premier partner of the Heisman Trophy. And Taco Bell's new Steak Boss Wraps.
We salute veterans on this Veterans Week, including the band from Fort Hood, Texas, the 1st Cavalry Division Band sitting in the stands, along with Baylor's Golden Wave Band, formed back in 1856. Travel around to promote spirit cavalry. Oklahoma has the lead after that drive in which they were aided by 20 yards in Baylor penalties. Chris Platt to boot it away. Nick Hodgson to boot it away and knocks it into the end zone. To Cassidy Hubbard with an update from the studio.
Thanks, Chris. Taco Bell studio update to the Big Ten. LaShawn Daniels Jr. capping off a drive that was 17 plays, going 91 yards, lasting 8.5 minutes. Hawkeyes up 7-0 over Minnesota. Back to you guys.
Iowa ranked just one spot ahead of Baylor, so the Bears fans will keep an eye on that one. Play a very different style of football, which is interesting for the committee to make their judgments. And we'll talk more about that as this story unfolds tonight. So Baylor trailing now for just the 17th offensive snap this season. Only trailed for 4:35 on the clock. And Wood just does not go down easily. Chaffin, it doesn't look like much, but it's about 7 yards.
Chippy on this side of the ball, too. And Baylor has been able to really control things up front. It's almost as if they're trying to get Oklahoma locked into the run game to set up their big plays in the pass.
Chaffin again. We have a first down at the 36. Ball comes out. Sooners say they have it. It's a scrum. They do. Turnover, Oklahoma. Jordan Evans knocked it loose.
And Devontae Bond was just kind of standing there. He thought the play was just about over. He happened to be standing there. He looks down. He sees the ball, and I think he just jumped on top of it. Watch number 23 come in from the left here. You see him. He's just kind of standing there. The ball pops down, and he jumps on top of it before Blake Muir can.
Sooners haven't forced a takeaway against Baylor since 2011. Third play. Evans made the strip. Allen Henry diving in there.
They'll probably take another look or two at this just to confirm the call downstairs.
Can't tell much from that angle whether the ball came out before the backside hit.
A fumble is under further review.
Yeah.
Don Capril is the Big 12 replay official.
And turnovers in a game like this where possessions are so critical. I mean, you're talking about a lot of points that are going to be scored in this football game. Whoever wins that turnover margin is going to have a big, big advantage, obviously, in any game, but especially in a game like this.
Before Chaffin's back hits the ground, you can see the ball come out.
It looks like the rear end
we have to look at.
Yeah. Those are the only two shots they have to peek at. Be hard, I think, to overturn that based on what we've seen so far.
Dave Kataya is our rules expert in the booth. Dave, if you were reviewing this, what would you see?
Well, we'd go with stands for the very reasons you guys are describing. Very difficult to see when the ball comes up, but Chris, you made a good point in that it looks like it starts moving before the back of the player hits the ground. I think it's going to stand.
Baylor has committed only 10 turnovers coming in. They're plus 11 in that department. It's a big part of their success.
After further review, the ruling on the field of a fumble is confirmed. First down.
A huge play for Mike Stoops' defense sets up the offense. Now the Baylor 38.
You were kidding Art Briles about breaking serve and, you know, and how he uses that term, and they really feel that that's, you know, one or two possessions here or there sometimes can be the difference in a game where a lot of points are scored. Let's see if Oklahoma takes advantage of it.
Mayfield throws a dart across the middle, and Shepard makes a catch and a first down at the 25-yard line.
Boy, great timing, and because Perine's running, watch the linebackers bite up on Perine. They bite up, it creates a nice throwing lane, and he throws a seed right behind the linebacker into Sterling Shepard in rhythm by Baker Mayfield.
Boy, is Shepard motivated. He's missed the last 7 quarters against Baylor. Couldn't play last year. Was knocked out early in the game 2 years ago. Already has 2 catches. Perine hit behind the line and dropped for a loss. And Baylor defensive linebackers getting good penetration.
Well, the big man Andrew Billings is finally healthy, and he is motivated to play well now that his ankle's recovered. He walked into our meeting, kind of looked at us like, we'll give you a few minutes here, but I got work to do. I'm ready to go this weekend. He's 6'2", 310 pounds, and playing the way a lot of people expected him to play. the last week or so. Looks good tonight. Off to a good start.
They like that matchup against Darlington, the Sooner center, don't they? With number 75. Second and 11, Mayfield takes a shot in the end zone, overthrown for D.D. Westbrook. There's a flag that's come out in the holding zone here.
Yeah, thrown right at the offensive line after the ball was thrown. I don't know if that was Mixon. Joe Mixon got involved there, the running back.
Defender looked like he went up high to try to bat the pass down.
Yeah.
And Mixon hit him.
After the play, personal foul, unnecessary roughness. Offense, number 78.
It was after the block,
15-yard penalty. It's second down.
That's a freshman making a big mistake.
It was after Mixon makes the block. Watch Joe Mixon, the running back, goes up, makes the block. Now watch 78 come down on top of it.
You got to be kidding.
Yeah, and it's the second time we've seen Oklahoma make a critical error as far as a little bit of too much with the extracurricular activities.
And that is inexcusable.
Twice.
Huge brain cramp. Moves the ball back to the 41.
Well, you've got to be able to control your emotions. That's what's frustrating Bob Stoops right there.
You want you guys hyped up, right? You want them to feed on
play with
emotion.
Emotion. Play under control. Yeah.
Third and 26. Mayfield escapes. Still alive. Still going. And now knocked down at the 40. It's a whole lot of running to gain about a yard. And the Sooners may have squandered that takeaway.
Well, you appreciate his heart. He's trying to keep this play alive. But this, I think, is what drives the coaches a little bit crazy when he does a little bit too much of that. I mean, this is early in the game. It's live for the next play. Throw it away or try to find a receiver downfield. But if there's nothing there, the creativity at some point you've got to give up on.
Seibert's been very effective at knocking punts dead inside the 20-yard line. And a fair catch is made by Hawthorne at the 9.
Missed opportunity by Oklahoma and a big stop by that Baylor defense.
Big time. Now, Seth Russell, an athletic dual-threat quarterback, tough guy, but made a decision to lower his head 3 weeks ago against Iowa State and suffered a fractured neck. So he has been in a brace. He told us the other day that he's got to go through 3 more months before they can evaluate it, see how that vertebra is healing. Just a model teammate. Really hurts not to be a part of this team, trying to support Stidham, Kirk, in any way that he can.
Absolutely. Baylor has been running the ball. You almost feel that they're getting ready to start attacking through the air.
Linwood caught up in traffic and knocked down after a 3-yard gain.
Coming into this drive, averaging 9 yards a carry. And what happens when a team starts to run the football like that, those linebackers and those safeties, they're going to start cheating down to Linwood, create some one-on-one opportunities on the outside for Corey Coleman.
Stidham's 3 completions for 4 yards. Nobody takes more deep shots in college football than the Baylor Bears.
He had 8 20-yard completions last week in his first career start at Kansas State.
It is raining hard. Makes the passing game a little trickier as they finally on cue take a shot. Coleman, a leaping catch, but he was out of bounds. Almost came down with a circus catch. Thomas was in coverage.
There it is. You knew it was coming. I'm sure Bob Stoops and Mike Stoops knew it was coming. One-on-one matchup. This is an area that really hurt Oklahoma. They feel much more confident with Jordan Thomas now as a sophomore and Zach Sanchez, number 15, on the other side. That time he's in good position and actually uses his body to force Coleman to the boundary.
And 3rd and 7, a whistle before the snap. Sooners were trying to get set up on defense. There was some confusion. They call timeout.
Oklahoma calls their first timeout of the half.
So Stoops defense looking for another stop when you come back to Waco.
Hubberth here. Let's take a look at who's getting it done, presented by Wells Fargo. Stanford trailing Oregon until Christian McCaffrey gets in for the touchdown. The Heisman hopeful puts the Cardinal back on top, 17-14, and they're in the red zone right now. Chris Irby, back to you.
Cassidy, thank you. Stoops furious. He felt that he should not have had to spend a timeout. His defense really wasn't allowed to sub or get set. Baylor had substituted. So 3rd and 7, Stidham in the pocket. Coleman makes a catch, first down. Accurate throw from this very gifted passer.
And that is a great job by Corey Coleman. We're known as a speedster getting by people. This time it gets zoned, just sits in the soft spot in the zone, and a heck of a throw by Stidham.
Linwood caught up in traffic. You've seen a lot of quarterbacks throw the ball. This 19-year-old kid, when the ball comes out of his hand, how many guys in college football ever have you seen throw a prettier spiral?
I'm sure we could sit back and think. I mean, Marcus Mariota comes to mind last year, but not as a true freshman. It's very rare to see a true freshman have the rotation and the spin on the ball the way Stidham does.
Stidham's roommate, the big senior, Spencer Drango, quick off the mark. You can see we've got the clock in. Baylor averaging about 16, 17 seconds in the first half between plays, and sometimes even a veteran gets caught up in the tempo and makes a mistake.
Absolutely. This rain is really picking up.
It sure is.
We've already seen some of the players slipping around.
They're on record pace if they can play this fast the rest of the season. Stidham, there's a drop. Wet ball, and a flag came out. Quarterback was being protected. Katie Cannon on the drop with some jawing over there.
This Oklahoma secondary has heard it all, not just all week, they've heard it all off season, what this Baylor offense did to them last year and the year before. They welcome the challenge. We'll see how they answer the call tonight on the perimeter. So far holding up well against Coleman and company.
Personal foul. Chop block, offense, number 69 and number 32. Happy distance to the goal, repeat second down.
So Linwood combining with Pat Colbert, the tackle, and the penalty.
This is a little questionable to me. Look at the right tackle, Colbert. He has to be engaged there, and this Dave should be great to come in. If the lineman is engaged and then he gets submarined by another player, that's where the chop block comes into play. It really looked like the defender had gone around Colbert there, and wasn't even really trying to deal with the tackle, and the line in the offense of the running back there chopped it.
Second and 26, Linwood wrestled down for a short gain by Eric Stryker, and this thing's going to get out of control. There are some hot tempers on both sides.
Yeah, you're gonna have to get control of the emotions, because if you don't, they're just going to continue to, the emotions will continue to escalate. But Oklahoma's defense, after a few mental mistakes by Baylor, really pinning their ears right now and attacking the line of scrimmage. Only allowed one play of 15 yards or longer tonight.
Stidham takes a downfield shot and has Coleman, who makes the catch in midfield. That's Jay Lee, excuse me, one of the receivers who's emerged in the last few games. Nice ball from Stidham.
Yeah, this is an inside receiver matched up against a safety, and he, you can see, even though he's got size at 6'3", 220, he can run by you. It's not just the outside receivers you got to worry about man-to-man. They attack the inside receivers against nickelbacks and safeties.
34-yard game. Now Stidham will loop it for Coleman, near side, over thrown out of bounds.
Tell you what,
Thomas is going to battle Coleman all night, isn't he?
Thomas is a sophomore, and he's being left on an island against one of the most explosive receivers in college football. And right now, he is not backing down and holding up just fine.
I said the rain was going to move out. If it came, it was going to arrive in the first half and then leave. I think both quarterbacks would like to see that forecast come true. It's tough. It's hard to tell on television, but the rain is coming down hard.
See the gamesmanship going on right now. Baylor substitutes, Oklahoma substitutes.
Play clock was at two. That's very rare they let it run down that far, and Chafin has no room to run.
It's a little bit of strategy by Bob Stoops. Kendall Briles and the Baylor offense substitute, and theoretically, the official will stand over the ball until the Oklahoma defense has made their substitutions, and they get in position. And Bob Stoops wasn't necessarily in a hurry to be able to make those substitutions.
Now the center judge backs out. Third and nine. Davion Hall came in motion. Stidham steps up. Wants to be very careful about running.
has to slide down before Jordan Evans could hit him. They don't want this quarterback to take any shots.
No, but they once they get to about midfield on fourth down, you're usually going to see them willing to go for this. And unless they're going to quick kick, they're lined up to go for it here on fourth down at midfield. This is Baylor football.
Stidham can pooch punt, did it against Kansas State. They've gone for it now 22 times. Final minute of the first quarter. The pooch, and this is a lot better than the one he tried the last game. And it's going to roll dead down inside the 8-yard line to Oklahoma's defense. Another stop, but they'll be pinned back after the 41-yard punt. Well, the Watch ESPN app is where you can stream every game live. Just download the app or go to watchespn.com. Our boy Nathan Folliwell, a huge Sooner fan, it's his wedding anniversary tonight.
I know his wife, Jesse.
They're in a restaurant. They're in a restaurant, but he's got the Watch app. He told me, dialed in on this game. Said, she let you get away with that? Says the Watch app travels with me.
He's a good man.
It's a
and she's a game. She's a very nice bride to allow him to have that at the table. He's probably the biggest Sooner fan out.
He's up there. Kings of Leon drummer, and his brothers and bandmates as well. So Mayfield, you got to be careful here with a wet football. They hand it off to Perine. Breaks a tackle. Cuts it back. Samaje Perine out near the first down marker, and they will move the chains across the 18.
Well, that is a heck of a run by Samaje Perine. He could have been tackled for about a 3-yard loss by Taylor Young. He ran right through that arm tackle and picks up a first down.
Now it's Mixon who makes the cut as the Sooners play fast and wedge in one final play before the end of the first quarter. A lot lower scoring than we thought, Mr. Herbstreit. End of one in Waco. Back after this message and a word from your local ABC station. But mishandled the snap on the conversion. Mayfield had the ball knocked out of his hands, gets a nice bounce and recovers it. Very fortunate. It came right up off this field turf into the hands of Mayfield. It'll be a loss in third down.
Brian Nance is undersized but incredibly athletic. He gets right by the freshman and knocks that ball loose. Mayfield fortunate to jump on top of that, but when Oklahoma's throwing the football, it's an obvious passing situation. The right tackle, Drew Samia, the true freshman, is being challenged by the experience and speed of Baylor's edge pressure.
I wonder if Lincoln Riley will risk a throw here if he'll just hand the ball off and punt. Mayfield tries to get it out. Quick far side. Shepherd on a screen. Cannot escape. Is knocked down at the 24. And the Sooners will have to punt.
Yeah, good job of leveraging the football on third down and anticipating by Chance Waz, the safety, to come up and make that play for Baylor's defense. Really, that was set up by Brian Nance on that second down play, being able to get the penetration and knock the ball loose from Baker Mayfield.
Seibert drives Hawthorne back to the 22, and the coverage team takes care of the rest. Thomas, the starting corner, flying down there in coverage to back up Baylor.
Cassidy Hubbard with your Dr. Pepper Championship Drive update. Stanford in a battle as Vernon Adams finds Darren Carrington, who somehow gets behind the Cardinal D. 47-yard touchdown. Stanford just kicked a field goal. They head into half, 23-21.
Pac-12 shootout. Relatively low scoring so far here as the handoff goes to Chafin. He's knocked down.
It's been interesting to see that Baylor's attack for the most part on the ground, but we have seen them throw the football, and they've shown some versatility in how they've attacked, whether they're facing man-to-man or zone.
Coleman to the left of the formation. There's a couple of catches, but they have limited yards after contact in the Bears with Chafin. Tests the ground game again, Kirk, but it's going to be third and long.
Yeah, third down, and now you get a freshman quarterback in an obvious passing situation. You get Oklahoma's front, and they can crank up pressure. You know, Charles Tapper, 91, does a good job of getting after it. And we all know about Eric Stryker, who's got 7.5 sacks coming into the night. We feel the depth and the athletic ability with this Sooners defensive line is more accustomed to what you've seen over the years in Norman with Bob Stoops this year.
They move Stryker around a lot. He's in the face of the quarterback. And he will be right there to combine in the sack. And they knock him down. Jordan Wade. And another stand by this OU defense.
And that's a coverage sack. When you've got a young quarterback, as talented as he is, you want to try to put him in a position where he has to be able to look into the face of this defense and deal with a lot of different white jerseys and the crimson helmets. Look at the coverage downfield. There's nowhere to go with the ball. And as a young quarterback, sometimes on third down, you get a little anxious. You look at your primary. He's not there. Your eyes go down and you start to bail. That's exactly what happened to Stidham there.
Drew Gielitz, it's a low kick, will bounce in front of Shepherd, and it'll take a good Baylor bounce, still rolling down inside the 21-yard line. Sooners back on offense, up a point.
Saturday Night Football, presented by Walmart, brought to you by Coca-Cola, Open Happiness, Buick, proud partner of the NCAA, and Jared, the Gallery of Jewelry. Come in for the one piece of jewelry she will love forever.
Rainy night in Waco as Goodyear provides our aerial coverage. Kick off your drive with tires that return superior performance. Goodyear, more driven, our official aerial provider. Rain continues to pelt down as the Sooners take over, protecting a one-point lead from their 20. Pirine hit immediately. Taylor Young, the weak side linebacker, came in. A flag is down.
Holding. Offense, number 56, 10-yard penalty, repeat first down.
It's the center, Garland, who's matched up against Andrew Billings. Tall order blocking this dude.
He is, and he actually gets involved here with Oakman as well. He's coming in on the right here, locked up with Sean Oakman. In this case, perhaps easy call for an official. Oklahoma continuing to make some mental errors and miscues, giving themselves first and 20 and getting off schedule.
Pirine makes a cut and spins and muscles across the 20. Heather Cox on the rainy sidelines.
Yeah, Chris, an update for you on Baylor's D-line. They're down one starter and one that's not 100%. Bo Blackshear right now out with a right knee injury. They retaped it from mid-calf all the way up to mid-thigh. He is not going to return. They'll reevaluate him at halftime and see if they can get him back in. Meanwhile, Sean Oakman, he is out there, guys, but he is not 100%, dealing with left knee swelling from last week and now has a right foot injury to add to it.
Wow. Mayfield rolling out, throws downfield. Westbrook has a step, but it's off his fingertips. He was in front of Howard and just overthrown.
Well, they take a chance. We've seen this Oklahoma offense tonight be willing to take some shots twice to Westbrook. He has a couple steps on him, and boy, the ball just thrown just a little bit too long. We put a little bit more air under it. Westbrook walks underneath of that and into the end zone. He got by X Howard on that play.
There's plays like that, potential opportunities that can decide a game like this, right? Who can connect on the deep shots?
This Oklahoma offense has such a different feel in 2015 than who they've been the last 3 or 4 years.
Mayfield and a whistle. A timeout call by Oklahoma. And spend a second, and it'll be third and 8. And the jawing continues down there.
Mayfield sometimes can't help himself. He's a very emotional guy.
After he took the snap, the timeout came from the sideline, and a couple of defenders came in, and they're chirping, and they're giving him a little bit of an elbow, and there are actually three Baylor defenders there at once, and he's letting them know he's not going to take it.
Oklahoma scored on their second possession. The Bears on their first. Since then, something shocking in the Big 12. Five possessions, a turnover in 4 points.
This probably has as much to do with it as anything. The whistle's blown. And
it's nice to get acquainted stuff.
Yeah.
How you doing, Baker? But I think that the Sooners have an attitude about Oakland, and I understand why. He was the guy that knocked their quarterback out a year ago. He's not afraid to get a little business down there in the scrum, that's for sure, number two. As Heather said, playing through some pain tonight. Mayfield on third down. Again, looking for Westbrook, and there comes a flag. Some of that hand fighting. That was Howard defending. The crowd didn't like it.
Pass interference. Defense, number four. 15-yard penalty.
Remember,
automatic first down.
We've already seen Westbrook get behind Howard a couple times. And I think that has as much to do with this as anything. He's by trying to get around him, you see the left arm working him and trying to prevent him, use the arm bar to try to not allow him to get by him again. That would have been a third time potentially he gets by him.
Obvious intent to impede is the way that rule is worded. There is a lot of it that goes on in this conference because the DBs are under such stress and put out in space. PIs are almost part of the game plan, drawing them, aren't they? Eron hammers ahead, just wrestled down after a 3-yard gain by Grant Campbell.
Well, Lincoln Riley has brought a new energy here as a play caller and offensive coordinator. And one of the things that he's doing is he's trusting Baker Mayfield, and he sees Dede Westbrook as a target he wants to go to.
Mayfield finds Shepard on the far side, dives for a first down. Riley graduated Texas Tech in 2006. I don't know if that makes you feel as old as I do. Youthful guy, one of the up-and-coming offensive lines was East Carolina after he was in Lubbock.
Did great things with Shane Carden a year ago at East Carolina, and I got Bob Stoops' attention.
Mishandled, attempted handoff. He pulled it back, and then Mayfield on that exchange was, again, lucky the ball bounced up to him. That's twice already.
I love that he didn't give up on the play, and he, you know, he's trying to pick up yards. There's still more pushing and shoving. But, you know, this is a zone read. Defender comes down. He reads it correctly. He's not able to hold on to the ball. But, you know, he's not giving up on his play. Taylor Young had a chance at him. He runs through a defender there in right, in Howard, the corner, picks up a few yards on a broken play.
Good fortune so far for Mayfield tonight. Sling it. Little slant. Shepard almost escaped, made the catch, and was trying to get away from the tackle from Vaughn's there at his first down.
The epitome of a slot receiver in college football. Look at the space to the right there. You get Sterling Shepard a matchup, and you create a little bit of space, he can make things happen after the catch.
Eron hit immediately hard behind the line of scrimmage and knocked down for a 2-yard loss.
Time Baylor does a good job of attacking down. It was Taylor Young, who's been very, very active in this game. He's 5'10", 225 pounds out of DeSoto, Texas. He's probably been the most aggressive of the entire front seven so far tonight. They got one-on-one matchups across the board. Baylor up tight at the line of scrimmage.
Bringing pressure. Mayfield back pedals, just heaves it downfield toward the goal line. Catch made. And now Shepard, they called a touchdown. Shepard made a terrific play. Battle into the end zone. That's the ruling on the field.
And this will be interesting. I'm glad Dave Kataya is up here because we always hear about finishing process and a catch. One-on-one matchup. We said they don't have any safeties back. They're blitzing. What a well-thrown ball. He reaches for that pylon, and that's when the ball came out.
We have cameras, Kirk, in the pylon. Here's as good a look as you'll ever see. Shepard reaching the ball. Makes contact right there. Hard to tell if he's down yet.
It looked like, Dave, he made two steps. You know, after the reception, he makes two steps with the football in his hands.
Is he out of bounds before he reaches that ball to the pylon or down? I don't think so.
No, it looks like a touchdown to me.
Another look from pylon cam.
The ruling on the field of a touchdown is under further review.
Those cameras are tough, and that's a good thing. There's four of them in each of the pylons, and that is a terrific look. And what a play, whether or not it stands by Shepard.
Well, when you get one-on-one matchups, and Baylor basically showed they tipped their hand. They showed we're blitzing, we're playing man. We saw it up here, man-to-man across the board. You got to find Sterling Shepard. He's your guy that wins those one-on-one battles. And he got separation. The ball was perfectly thrown by Baker Mayfield right over the shoulder.
Another look. What a heady play. It's a milestone catch for Shepard, the 200th of his career for 39 yards. Again, this guy couldn't play last year against Baylor.
Under further review, the ruling on the field of a touchdown is confirmed.
Yep.
Nobody more eager and pumped up on the offensive side of the ball than Shepard for this game.
Especially after the last 2 years, he's wanted an opportunity. He's one of the leaders. Dave, let's bring in Dave Kataya just to confirm what we saw there, Dave.
That was a really good call. The reason is the secondary act of him extending the ball and hitting the pylon. That denotes the completion of the catch with that secondary act.
That effort by extending, okay.
Correct.
Seibert knocks it through. A terrific job by the holder there, Grant Botham. Actually, it's not good. Botham had to collect a snap that was behind him, so either team automatic on conversions on a wet night, but the Sooners up by 7.
Go back and look. What was great about this, if you're an Oklahoma fan, is Baker Mayfield on the road, tough environment, recognizing man-to-man coverage, and he gets to the matchup that he wants. You see Shepard at the bottom, but watch the running back, Samaje Perine. Watch what he does here, right there on the block, to be able to give him just enough time. Grant Campbell came on the blitz. Samaje Perine picks up the blitz. It's an area that you can really see how much he's grown. Mayfield still gets hit, by the way. But there's the extension and the touchdown and the one-on-one matchup, which is going to be a battle tonight with Sterling Shepard against that Baylor secondary.
Looked like Perine enjoyed throwing that block, didn't he?
Sure did.
Hodgson's kick will not be brought out. So the Bears playing from behind. The deficit now 7 points. Monday night. The Red Rifle, the guy Andy Dalton, and the undefeated Cincinnati Bengals.
Who did?
Taking on J.J. Watt and the Houston Texans at 6 o'clock Monday Night Countdown. Kickoff at 8:15, also on the Watch ESPN app.
How about that ball club? Playing pretty good. Andrew Whitworth and the boys.
They are. Now you're not going to talk noise. You've been talking noise the first half of the season. Now you're going to downplay the Bengals.
Exactly.
Now, okay.
Exactly. Mikey T and the boys getting into town in Cincinnati. Coach Gruden.
Baylor has not faced a 7-point deficit yet this year. They've been the kings of game control, that metric that looks at how much dominance they have throughout the course of the game. And on first down, the Sooners are swarming Linwood again. He had the one long run early, but they've been all over him since.
Unbelievable what they've been able to do and the way they've settled in. At first drive, 8-9 plays, 80 yards and a touchdown. It looked like ho-hum. That's typical Baylor. But look at these last three drives, and now to start this drive here, another stop.
Play action. And the ball caught by Lee. A terrific hands grab just a few inches off the turf at the 32. It'll be third down. Linwood stacked up, hit, fighting hard, will not get first down yardage as Zach Sanchez, the corner, came up in support at 179 pounds.
He comes up, and watch Charles Walker, Chris. Watch the defensive line from Oklahoma. Remember when they were getting pushed around? Look in the middle. Look at 97 get extension. He's just throwing. He's throwing the Pat Colbert, the right tackle, back into the backfield, and Sanchez cleans it up.
Well, Sanchez got knocked to the ground, but he grabbed the ankle.
He got a hold of something. But that defensive line from Oklahoma, and that all three plays There's a lot, little bit of different feel from the Sooners' confidence that they have right now.
How about four straight empty drives for Baylor? You just never see that. Shepard making the fair catch. Oklahoma back to work midway second quarter, up by seven. They like our buddy Chris Felica here in Waco with the nickname the Bear, and he's always going to deliver our Affleck trivia question. What do you have tonight, Bear?
Talk some Heisman Trophy here for you. Of course, RG3 won the 2011 Heisman Trophy. A couple of Baylor players may be in contention this year. Who's the only other Bear to finish in the top five for Heisman voting?
Is it Singletary, perhaps? Are we thinking maybe on the other side of the ball?
Maybe a trick question with the Bear. It's always a trick question. I'm with you. I'm with Singletary.
First and 10. Mixon motions back in. It's a two-back look, and Mayfield pump fakes. It's downfield. We're into a crowd broken up, intended for Neal. Chance Wise in coverage. Last five completions by Mayfield have been to Sterling Shepard as he targets his top receiver.
That's smart. You're on the road in this environment against this offense. You know that number 32, P. Ryan, and number 3, Shepard, have got to get their hands on the ball as often as possible. Remember, he's been taking shots to the left into the boundary to 11 Westbrook against Howard. See if he tries to go back to that.
Mayfield steps up, throws it short again at Shepard. Trying to make the corner, gets the 41-yard line, very near the marker. Trayvon Blanchard stopped him. If you're an Oklahoma fan, you're cautiously optimistic, but you remember it was 14-3 in Norman a year ago, and then 45 straight for the Bears in a beatdown. Third and short. Mayfield on the keeper, takes a shot. Knocked out by Howard. It'll be close. I think it's going to be a first down. Yep.
Sooners fighting for every inch there. Baker Mayfield, you and I were talking at the break. He's had a great start to this game. He's had a couple plays where the ball has bounced his way, but he's got a little bit of an edge to him, a little bit of confidence and swagger that this offense seems to feed off of.
I agree. His teammates say that. Again, dangerous throw into traffic. Blanchard, the linebacker, with a takeaway. The kind of thing Mayfield has avoided this season. This time they were all over his top target.
He throws this ball behind Shepard, which allows Blanchard to get underneath it. And remember, Blanchard, Phil Bennett tells us he runs a 4-4. He played corner in high school. See how Shepard has to wait for the ball? That allows Blanchard, with his closing speed, to step right in front of that football. And what soft hands by Blanchard to hold onto the ball, gets his body underneath before he hits the ground and potentially loses possession of the ball.
Great point, Kirk. Watch the awareness to roll the body, not let the ball hit the ground. What an athletic pick for Blanchard, his second of the season.
It's almost like Baylor needed something to kind of spark this stadium, this crowd, and give their offense great field position. Blanchard provides it.
One takeaway for each defense, and they continue to try to hammer Chuck Linwood. Evans stopped them after about a 4-yard gain.
Well, they have a lot of confidence in that offensive line. We talked earlier, they're averaging over 300 yards a game on the ground. And they'll keep going back to it and set up the play action.
Take it to Linwood. Stidham gets around the edge and get down, young man. That's what Art Briles is thinking. Eric Stryker was in the neighborhood. It'll be third and short. Heather?
Well, Chris, Baker Mayfield just went down his entire offense and said, hey, that one's on me. My mistake. It won't happen again. I'm going to continue going deep. Kirk, you were talking about a matchup that they're exploiting. He wants to continue to pass.
Linwood breaks free. First down and much more down to the 22-yard line. Amon Thomas on the tackle, but he took the blow.
Now this time, since the opening drive, we've not seen him be able to squirt through there. The double team opens it up.
Linwood again. The Bears love to play extra fast after making a first down. That time, knocked down for a loss.
You know, what's happening in some of their pass plays, the reason we're not seeing big plays is Mike Stoops has elected to rush four and drop seven and play zone. And Baylor only has three wide receivers going out for some of these passes. So you've got seven defenders, only three guys out going out for a route. It's a good job by Mike Stoops.
Coleman is uncovered. The Sooners are confused on defense. And there's a run by Linwood.
There's a flag in the play. There was a lineman running off just before the ball was snapped, and Coleman was basically uncovered in the slot.
They got 12 players on the field. He was uncovered, but you had DJ Ward trying to get off the field.
12 men on the field. Defense. 5-yard penalty. 18 second down.
Happens a lot trying to defend this tempo offense. Mike Stoops is up in the booth for the first time. He's been on the sidelines his whole career.
He's frustrated. Right here, you see him. He's confused. Well, am I on? Am I off? Am I on? He's the 12th man. You're right. When they stress you not only from a scheme, but the mindset and who's in and who's out, and let's make sure we're matched up with the personnel groupings.
Chapin running behind the largest human in a football uniform, I think, Laquan McGowan, 6'7", 410-pound tight end slash lead blocker. Was in that time, number 80.
Yeah, when in doubt, just follow the big fella. Look at him.
And they sneak it on third and short. They just maul that defensive line as McGowan joins the scrum. It'll be first down. Big Laquan, the big truck, they call him.
I shook his hand yesterday and I lost it. I lost my hand. I mean, we've watched him catching the football.
Soft hands, though.
He does. And down in this red zone area, don't forget, they threw the one pass last year in the bowl game. And he does have soft hands for a big fella.
500-pound bench press, size 20 shoe. Sidham batted down at the line. He was trying to get it to Coleman on a slant, but Tapper got a hand up.
That's been a big, big emphasis this week in Norman, is the ball is out fast with Stidham in this system. And if you can't get in there, you've just got to be athletic enough to try to time it up. And Tapper does an excellent job there.
Thomas on Coleman to the left of the formation, Kirk. Second and 10. And a quiet start to this game for the Heisman candidate. Play clock winding down to 5. Option look. Cooper, big hit delivered. Stephen Parker came up and knocked the quarterback down. You don't want to get him hit, but down here in the red zone, you got to run him, they feel.
Yeah, and the speed option was a part of their offense in his start in Manhattan, and they feel he's athletic enough to run it, but you're right. There isn't a lot of talent, a lot of experience behind Stidham, but you got to take some chances. You can't be too protective of your quarterback.
You just got to minimize shots like that. Parker hit him hard. 3rd and 5, they can make a first down at the 1.
Chris, you talked about the matchup up here at the top. Thomas has done a very good job as well.
Well, against Corey Coleman, who's been almost impossible to defend with single coverage and sometimes beats double coverage, an opportunity for Jordan Thomas to really shine tonight.
Sure is.
Football world is watching him. All right, Bear, we have this break. We guessed Mike Singletary might have been the highest finisher for the Heisman here at Baylor until RG3 won it. What is the answer to the Aflac?
Well, you have to go all the way back to 1963. Don Troll, quarterback of Baylor, finished 4th to Roger Staubach, the Navy quarterback. Think we might have another Navy quarterback in New York this year invited there? Keenan Reynolds put up some great numbers.
Bear, are you serious? Pulling in a 1963?
Troll? What is he? What's he throwing, a lateral there? Number 10? He's a Hall of Famer. Give Don Troll his due.
That's my bowling technique right there.
Bear stumped us. Well, can the Bryles dial up for Stidham here, the freshman quarterback on 3rd and 5?
Well, they've moved, and look to the left here. They've moved Coleman now into the slot. Try to change the matchup. You have Thomas up to the outside, way at the top, and they've created a different matchup now on the inside for Coleman.
Fake it to Chapin. Stidham scrambling. And he's going to be hit and knocked down at the 5-yard line. Dominique Alexander was waiting for him. Now they slam him down, and here comes a flag. Another mental mistake by an over-aggressive Sooner defense. They had him stopped. It was going to be a field goal attempt.
Maybe.
After the play, personal foul, unnecessary roughness. Defense number 1. Have the distance to the goal. Automatic first down.
You could lip read Stoops. He said, you got to be kidding me. That is a potential 4-point play right there. Mike Stoops, it's probably a good thing he's not in the sidelines. Yeah, he might run out and strangle somebody.
Yeah, it's better to have him up there tonight with some of these mistakes that they're making. And the problem is it's coming from their leaders. Alexander here the junior, the number one defender in that second level. We've also seen Jordan Evans. He was miscues and mistakes costly for Oklahoma at crucial times as well.
Chapin on first and goal just walks in. Seven when it should have been three if not for the personal foul. And the Bears a chance to tie it.
Let's not forget to give Trevon Blanchard an assist there with that big interception to give the Bears great field position to get the crowd back into this game. And it's a totally different feel now, potentially a tie game if they hit this extra point.
She have not been automatic tonight. Each team has missed an extra point. Wet football, some troubles with the snaps and the holds. This is Chris Callahan, who had his first missed attempted PAT of the season, knocks this one through. So a 39-yard drive after the interception by Blanchard. As we check the marker and a scrum after the PAT. Tempers continue to flare up here. Very feisty first half. Stoops letting Alexander know that was a crucial mental mistake. A Baylor first and goal. Sort out the penalties are here. Reggie Smith, we thought he and his crew might be busy tonight, and they have been. Devin Chafin has scored a couple of touchdowns on the ground.
The result of the play is a successful try for a point. After the play, unsportsmanlike conduct, Oklahoma number 94, he kicked a player and by rule has disqualified himself from the game. The 15-yard penalty will be enforced on the kickoff.
That's Matt Diamond, who's been ejected from the game. Meanwhile, Baylor has forced a turnover for the 25th consecutive game, and it set up the touchdown.
Well, you can see Bob Stoops' of frustration. This is, you're right, what set it up. Blanchard makes the interception, gives this Baylor offense the field position that they needed. This is after the penalty, first and goal. Chapin just walks into the end zone.
Just beautiful blocking. And not much for the running back to do, but just waltz in.
No, and then what the starting defensive lineman here, Matt Diamond, has now been kicked out of the game for kicking a Baylor player.
Very hard for us to spot it. We're looking to see if we can give you an angle of it. The officials, though, spotted it in there. Little taunting of the Baylor crowd from Diamond as he walks off. Junior from Katy, Texas. This team came in here stoked up. We knew they were hungry for redemption. They have lost their cool at key moments here, though, already in the first half.
It was right in the middle, right there over the snapper, Landis. He's right on top of the, right there. He just brings his foot down on the long snapper. Officials all over it.
He was laying on his back and then brought his foot down on the face mask.
Yep.
And the immediate flag there. So a tie game. As you said, Oklahoma down the starting defensive lineman for the rest of this game, and after the penalty, the Bears will kick it off from midfield. Try the pooch kick, and the fair catch is made by Oklahoma at the 29-yard line. So 2:58 to go until halftime, tied at 13. Tomorrow, week 10 in the NFL, and the insiders will get you covered in this Sunday edition at 10 o'clock Eastern time over on ESPN, followed by Sunday NFL Countdown at 11, streaming live on the Watch ESPN app. Well, it's been surprisingly low scoring, Kirk. The defense have made some plays, couple takeaways, a whole bunch of penalties, a very feisty first half.
I mean, you have one timeout for Oklahoma with just under 3 minutes to go. With the way Baker Mayfield has played, I'm sure they're going to be aggressive and try to get in position here for some points.
In motion, Mixon into the slot. Hand it to Piron, who has both hands on the football as he powers ahead for a 5-yard gain.
Who would have thought, with all the buildup and the hype and all the talk about the Big 12 in the month of November and early December, and all the points are you going to see. He had a 13-13 score here potentially at the half.
Mayfield pulls it and fires across the middle. Catch made by Shepard at the 50. Already Shepard with the touchdown catch and now has 8 receptions tonight.
Now watch, he's reading this linebacker, and because he came up, he pulls the ball out and then he finds his crossing route.
The backs cross, Mayfield rolls and fires far side again. A low throw and a catch made by Shepard is having a monster first half.
You know, by going tempo like this, it not only helps you get in field position, but it allows you to have such an edge to you as an offense, and it gets the defense on its heels.
Second and short, Mayfield sneaks it for a first down to the 40. Sooners had to spend the 2 timeouts. They have just 1, but 2:01 to work with. Plenty of time.
Remember, Shepard has been bouncing around. He's been in the slot. He's been to the field. He's been to the boundary. Right now, he will be up at the top of the screen.
Mayfield lobs it down and makes it out of the backfield. On a wheel route, got open down inside the 25.
And because you have Shepard on the same side, he's able to catch a lot of the defense's attention. He's just going to go right down here on the wheel route. But you see the safety has to respect Sterling Shepard. It opens up that sideline for the wheel route to mix it.
18-yard gain, and now Piron runs the right side. With Lincoln Riley, that young play caller, with a nice rhythm now, isn't he?
He really does. And I think the combination of Mixon and Piron in the backfield together, you have Sterling Shepard out there making plays. We've not seen Mark Andrews, the freshman, yet have an opportunity, but he has great size, especially down here at 6'5". He's now up at the top. He just came in for Shepard.
Winker, Andrews, 6 touchdowns in his 16 catches. He's got single coverage to the right of the quarterback. Mayfield pulls it, throws back over the middle, and the catch is made by Dimitri Flowers, and the H-back muscling down to the 1.
Where the flow all the way to the right gets the defense's attention. They've been going down that right sideline, and he just puts the ball up in the air and hopes that Flowers will come down with it. Watch the defense flow to the right, and it opens up the middle of the field, and he relies on the athletic ability of Flowers to go up and make a play. That's trust right there by Baker Mayfield, throwing it to his H-back, Flowers, who goes up and takes that big hit and almost works his way into the end zone.
Ryan Stewart, who is a big hitter in the secondary, he delivered the shot, but he took the worst of it against
sure
the
did.
Physical Flowers.
Oklahoma has run 41 plays, 21 runs and 20 passes. That is outstanding balance to start this first half by Lincoln Riley.
Stewart collided with the other safety, Waz, against Kansas State. He actually knocked Waz out of the game, and you could see that he's struggling, and that would be a serious loss for this Baylor defense. They count so much on their safeties.
Oh yeah.
Trying to get off the field, then went down again. So 56 seconds before halftime, the Capital One Halftime Report. John Saunders, Mark May, and Mac Brown coming up. And also ABC News will have an update on the aftermath of the attacks in Paris yesterday. As Stewart is helped off. Oklahoma in 2 minutes and 2 seconds so far has moved 69 yards, threatening to retake the lead again in Waco. Tayon Sells, number 26, the junior, in for Stewart. 2 back look.
And working that play clock.
They could work it down and leave Baylor.
They should. They should. The way Baylor can score and the way they move the ball. Should work that down as far as they can.
Mayfield finally says, all right, let's go. B-line. Nope, keeps it, pulled it. Fool me, fooled the defense. Touchdown, Oklahoma. What a first half for Mayfield.
Yeah, the zone read, Chris. He fooled you. You're right, he fooled Baylor. Blanchard came down hard on Piron, who's had a great first half himself. Catches the linebacker's attention, and Baker Mayfield does a great job of staying on the ride and pulling that ball out. A perfect read, and he walks into the end zone.
Seibert, no trouble with that conversion. 28 seconds in halftime. Sooners back up by a touchdown.
He calmly lets the play clock go down. He's going to make this read right here. And because Blanchard collapses, makes it very easy. He's collapsing down on Piron. There's nobody out here to the outside. And he walks into the end zone. I love to see quarterbacks take their time. He worked the play clock down. And then he doesn't predetermine what he's going to do with the ball. Simply makes the read off of number 48, Blanchard. Pulls it, gets into the end zone.
Mayfield on that drive, 4 for 4, 61 yards, ran it a couple times and finished it off here.
It's 15 to 20, 182. On the road in this environment, run the football a handful of times.
Baylor. 28 seconds until halftime, and we'll get the ball to start the second half. But this crowd, dressed in all black, came out charged up. I think they thought they'd see a typical Baylor offensive fireworks show, and the Sooners defense not having it in the first half.
Not at all.
This is Corey Coleman. He's going to bring it out. Why not give it a go? Top receiver. Does not return kicks too often. He is knocked down hard. The Sooners have terrific coverage units. There's a flag down. Daniel Brooks, one of the backup linebackers, was down there to knock Coleman down. We'll check
there
the marker.
There is no foul for a block in the back on the play. It's first down.
Northwestern Mutual presenting college football playoff selection committee rankings. Clemson struggled a bit, but 1-10 at the Dome, survive in advance. Ohio State workmanlike. Iowa with a 10-point lead over Minnesota.
There's Alabama with that one loss. Another impressive win.
Stanford down 5 to Oregon in that rivalry game in the Pac-12 North.
See LSU after the loss last week in Tuscaloosa struggling against Arkansas.
Hogs came out and they got a little bit of a fracas with LSU pre-kickoff in Baton Rouge tonight. Now, so far they're backing it up. So Stidham heaves it near side, and the catch is made. KD Cannon, one of the speedsters, knocked down short of the 30, and they'll move the chains 14 seconds a half.
Yeah. See if they're able to. We're going to try maybe one more shot here. But Oklahoma's defense.
Cannon again, tripped up, dives, tries to get out of bounds, and does at the 33. With 7 seconds left.
They have been able to keep 7 defenders against a pass in coverage for most of the game. And they've taken away Stidham in this explosive passing game. And they're saying, you know what, if they're going to move the ball, it's going to be Shock Linwood. We'll take our chances with our talented defensive line and linebackers against the running game. But they're not going to hit the explosives downfield in the pass game.
Stidham will just flip it again to Cannon. And with 1 second on the clock, Baylor will have one chance to heave it down. Now they're talking about it, whether or not the catch is going to count.
And failed to reestablish inbounds prior to touching the pass. It is incomplete. Third down.
It's the call that got so much attention last week in the Michigan State-Nebraska game. Here, Cannon definitely stepped out of bounds and came back in, so he's ineligible.
Less repercussions on this play than on that call. So empty backfield. Stidham. See if he tries to heave it long. They just try to throw it short. Now the catch is made by Davion Hall, who has some running room, but now will be surrounded by Sooners and brought down. And this offense that averages 8.4 yards per play, best in the FBS, averaging far less than that tonight. End of the first half here in Waco. The Capital One Halftime Report is coming up. John and the gang in the studio and Heather Cox will speak with Bob Stoops right after these messages.
set for the second half on Saturday Night Football on ABC, presented by Walmart. Here in Waco, Texas, the rain is letting up as we get set for the final 30 minutes. A surprising first half. Surprisingly defensive Oklahoma with a 20-13 lead. Chris Fowler back with Kirk Herbstreit. But Kirk, the Sooners have been here before. They play great defense for 30 minutes. Now, what's the key to sustaining it? Because in the second half, the Bears have stepped on the gas the last couple of years against them.
No doubt about it. I think their defensive line really started to assert themselves after the opening drive where Baylor went right down the field and put points up on the board. And because of how well they played up front, it's allowed them to defend the run with their front and then still keep a lot of guys in coverage. And it's made it really hard on Jared Stidham, the freshman quarterback. We'll see if they can maintain the same effort from Oklahoma in the second half. And if you're Baylor, it's about trying to get your running game going, taking some of the pressure off of Stidham, which they tried to do.
Let's check with Heather Cox before the kickoff.
All right, guys, I talked to Art Briles, who was frustrated with the rhythm, said we just got out of rhythm, out of sync early, and we never got back into it, and that turnover really hurt momentum. One last night, guys, keep your eyes on quarterback Jarrett Stidham. Art Briles admitted to me that he got banged up in the first half. He's dealing with a very sore back, but will continue in the second half.
They don't want to get this guy hit because there really is no experience behind him. The Pacific Life game summary, big first half for Sterling Shepard, again, who missed last year's game with an injury.
Yeah, 9 receptions at 118 yards. He's putting his heart and soul into this effort, providing the leadership. We talked about Jarrett Stidham, 9-13, but the Sooners keeping everything in front of them. Very few passes. This is one of the few passes downfield where they hit Jay Lee, and that's what they're going to try to do here, try to hit some big plays in a pass game.
Stidham takes a shot. That sore back won't feel any better after that big blow from Matt Romar.
Remember, we have Matt Diamond out of the game for kicking a Baylor player, so Romar, along with Charles Walker, have got to get it done in the middle, and much like the way most of the first half went, again, that Sooner D-line.
Linwood knocked down after a short gain. It'll be third and long. This is a Baylor offensive line that's given up only 9 sacks on the season. Crowd just not used to seeing this offense shut down. There's a murmur in this place. They need 14.
You're going to see 7 in coverage here.
Stidham takes a shot for Coleman. Fingertip catch, flag comes in. He's knocked out of bounds near the Oklahoma 40. Let's check the marker.
That's got to be pass interference, I think, on the Sooners, and Will Johnson trying to prevent Coleman from getting around him.
That hand fighting that goes on down the field, defensive back and receiver.
Prior to the pass, holding, defense, the penalty is declined. Result of the play, first down.
And you could see that Jordan Thomas, who Oklahoma wants to have on Coleman with the formation, they somehow got Coleman matched up with the nickelback Will Johnson, and that's a matchup they'll take every time.
Quiet first half for Coleman, only 2 catches for 14 yards. He got 37 on that third down play. Now Linwood is just mobbed and slammed down by Charles Tapper. Another loss on first down.
Well, again, I can't say enough about the way this defensive line is playing. You're talking about not only going up against a team that can score, but you have a veteran Baylor offensive line, a physical back in Shaq Linwood, a team that's averaging 300 yards a game on the ground, and Oklahoma with the rotation and athletic ability winning that battle.
Linwood has a crease. At the ankle there by Alexander, prevented a bigger gain. It'll be 3rd and 4. Very few negative plays for this offense, only 40 all year. The Sooners did a very good job at having it behind the line. On third down, Linwood muscles forward. Don't even need to go for it on fourth down because they will move the chains to the 31.
But Art Briles made an interesting point with Heather, talking about they got out of rhythm. They had some penalties and miscues and the turnover and kind of got away from what they were doing early.
Stidham thought about running and now just dumps it off on the sidelines. That's Cannon making the catch. Quarterback knocked down again. Completion to the 25.
And they brought a late blitz from Stephen Parker, the nickelback, to right there, number 10. He leaves Cannon. Stidham eventually sees that. He probably should have gotten that out there a little bit earlier to Cannon, but he did take a hit by Parker.
Linwood tries to cut back. gets the edge. Shock Linwood. Another cut down inside the 10. First and goal, Bears.
So I think that's what makes Shock Linwood so good. This play is designed to go to the left. It's a counter play. He's going to follow his lineman. But look at this. This play is supposed to go here. He cuts it all the way back because of the vision and the feel that he has there. Does a good job of coming off of that. See, all the way back. The play is designed to his left.
Looking for a third touchdown and getting it is Devin Chafin. The big play, 37 yards, Kirk, in that third and 14 to keep the drive going. And Chafin with the hat trick.
It's kind of how the opening drive of the game started, really, for Baylor. 9 plays, 75 yards here. They go right down the field, 232. It's almost identical to that opening drive to start the game for their first touchdown.
PATs have not been automatic tonight. It's Callahan who knocks this one through. And this game tied once again at 20. Baylor quick out of the starting gate in the second half, just as they were in the first. 3 touchdowns for 2-8. The bridges across the Brazos normally lit up green and gold for Baylor home games, but red, white, and blue tonight, the colors of the French flag in support in the memory of the victims of the terrorist attacks, more than 125 killed in that city. Prayers for Paris from even as far away as Waco, Texas, and all of us here join in our thoughts and wishes. As the Bears have tied the score quickly, their first possession of the third quarter. Evans kick taken at the 4 by Alex Ross. And was a very dangerous returner last year, had a couple touchdowns, but they haven't been that strong in this department this year. Celebrating its 11th year sponsoring the Good Hands Field Goal, and that's Allstate. Makes contributions to the general scholarship funds for each field goal and extra point kicked. Allstate has contributed millions of scholarship funds so far. This Oklahoma offense from the 26-yard line. Baker Mayfield so sharp. In command in the first half. Can they keep it going? Green is almost stopped, which is good news for both offenses. Piran bounces off a man. Gets to the edge, just runs through the tackle of Stewart, and they'll move the chains. Heather?
Well, some defensive news for Baylor. As you'll recall, defensive taker Bo Blackshear injured his right knee in the first half. They evaluated it at halftime. He will not return. Also, starting safety Orion Stewart is out there, but battling back spasms.
Heather, thank you. Byron Bonds, one defensive tackle, already out with a knee strain. Now Kirk Blackshear unable to return. Heather reported that Oakman is dealing with a couple of lower body injuries.
And now look at this. You have Andrew Billings down. He's going to get up. He's been fighting through an ankle injury for the last few weeks.
Sure has. Still not 100%, he told us. Mayfield pulls it. Pump fakes. Takes a shot. And throws it far side to Neal, who's knocked out of bounds at the 45-yard line. Here's a quarterback who's in rhythm right now.
Yeah, no doubt about it. And they're starting to run the football. And when you start to run the ball, it opens up spacing underneath in this offense. And boy, he had Shepard matched up against Stewart there.
Piran hammers away at that short-handed defensive line. The linebacker Campbell came up to meet him.
Oh. Baylor doing everything they can to hold up physically. The strength of their defense is their defensive line, but they're beaten up. Which means the linebackers and safeties are going to have to get more involved.
Mayfield escapes, has room. Mayfield to the 30, shows the speed, gets the corner, knocked out down inside the 10. Blanchard finally ran him out, but another big play from the quarterback.
I'm telling you, we've not seen an Oklahoma Sooner quarterback that brings this kind of life to this offense in years. His creativity, look at the effort. He's not going to give up on this play. He's not looking to slide. He's picking up as many yards as he can.
34 of them on that scamper, first and goal.
Great block downfield by Westbrook to help him give him more yards.
Beeline hammered immediately. That was Campbell coming up again to join in on the tackle with KJ Smith.
As much as the Oklahoma defense has taken the brunt of the criticism about why they can't play with teams like Baylor or TCU, it's really been more about the offense. Tonight's a different story with Mayfield and company.
Second to go. Mayfield has it, throws near side off the hands of Mark Andrews, the rangy freshman receiver. It was a big red zone weapon for the Oklahoma team.
Tried the back shoulder fade to the bigger freshman. It's 6'5 to go up there. Ball is in perfect position, and Andrews just unable to hold on to the football. It's exactly where you want to put it if you're a quarterback. That back shoulder fade with a 6'5 receiver, you put it up in the air. It's almost like a rebound. The timing was good. He just lost his footing and his balance, couldn't hold on to it.
Third and goal. Mayfield on a slant. Touchdown. Shepherd went down low, scooped it up, and Oklahoma takes the lead again.
Chris, look how Baylor's walked up. They're blitzing, which creates a nice big void right behind the blitz. Baker Mayfield has time, finds it, waits for the right moment. You'll see Blanchard go up in the air. He throws it right behind him, right low and away where it needs to be.
Conversion good. Shepherd now, 10 catches, 125 yards, and 2 touchdowns. And Stoops' offense converts again in the red zone, back up by 7.
Saturday Night Football, presented by Walmart. Stop by a store or visit us at walmart.com to share wonder every day. Ford, we go further so you can. And Chick-fil-A, we didn't invent the chicken, just the chicken sandwich.
Conditions have improved for the blimp here. Aerial coverage brought to you by Goodyear. Everything Goodyear has learned, making tires that go the distance, inspires what they roll into yours. Goodyear More Driven, our official aerial provider. Rain seems to have moved off to the east. You see both offenses get it cranked up. Each scoring to open this third quarter, and Oklahoma again has reclaimed the lead. Nick Hodson drives it into the end zone. Most of his kicks are touchbacks, and that one is as well. Booker, Tuesday night on ESPN, you're off to Chicago. It's a special time. The new college football playoff rankings presented by Goodyear will be released. Reese, you, others, I guess, from the United Center in Chicago between games of the Champions Classic. So we'll see how developments of today might change the committee's outlook. Alabama, be impossible to drop them after they hammered Mississippi State on the road. Clemson and Ohio State winning. Iowa involved in Minnesota tonight and lead by 6, but style points do count.
They do, especially this time of year.
Stidham wanted to take a shot downfield, and that just rolls and bounces the ball in there incomplete to Hall. This offense that's known, Kirk, for all these deep shots.
This is an example of what you're going to see. You're going to get a guy down here, but look at the Oklahoma Sooners. In coverage, look how tough this is to find an opening to throw the football to.
Chafin to carry, and it's going to be third down again. Alexander on the stop.
It's interesting that Mike Stoops has come up with a plan. He's looked at it the entire offseason, and it's all really relying upon having a dominant defensive line and playing the way they're playing physically at the line of scrimmage against the run game and pressuring the quarterback, which frees him up to drop linebackers and defensive backs in coverage against the big playability in the pass.
And third and 7, it's a slant off the fingertips of Coleman, who was closely covered. Fourth down coming up, and more jawing between Coleman and DBs. Thomas.
It's a tight window, and you know, Coleman, as good as he is, he knows when he goes in there, there's a chance you're gonna feel a linebacker. In this case, it was Alexander. Gets around Thomas. The ball is thrown where he can make a catch on it, but he short-armed it just a bit, fearing Dominique Alexander closing in.
Bear has had only 8 three and outs all season coming in. That was their third tonight. Gaylett's much busier than usual. Not a very good punt. Bounce backwards. And let's see where they spot it. It'll be at the 43 as Oklahoma takes over up 7.
Chicago, my town, where past champions will clash.
All I want is everything you got to it all.
And future champions will be decided. The Champions Classic and College Football Playoff Top 25, all live from Chicago Tuesday on ESPN.
It was a 27-yard punt. It was a funky into it. Watch Dakota Austin, number 27, down in coverage, and boink, right off the helmet.
Lucky that ball happened to bounce out of bounds for Oklahoma. You imagine if that bounced back into the field of play?
Been a live ball instead. Oklahoma at the 45, trying to build on the 7-point lead. Mixon, the running back at the bottom of the formation. It's Perine who's got it, makes a cut. Samaje Perine in the clear. Stiff arm, still running. Touchdown, Oklahoma. 55 yards. And the Sooners go up 2 scores. Physical, tough, and fast.
I just cannot believe the job that Lincoln Riley has done with this offense, from the way they looked against Texas to where they've looked these last 5 weeks, including tonight. This team had 67 yards rushing against Texas.
His longest run allowed by Baylor this year.
And give Lincoln Riley credit here, Chris, because look at the formation. He's got Shepard over here. By doing that, he gets a linebacker and a safety over here. There's nobody in run support on this side. And the reason that's important is once he gets through, you got a blitz right there. You get a nice block from the right tackle, Samia. And it just frees it up. And I'll tell you, the big fella has speed when he gets out into the open field. But look, there's nobody there. Blanchard blitzes. He gets picked up right there. And there's nobody left because the formation moved the safeties into the boundary.
And here's a look at pylon camera. Samaje steamrolling into the end zone. It's shorthanded Baylor defensive line down. Blackshear already missing Bonds, Oakman, and Billings. Both of them banged up. Beginning to wear, and you're right, Lincoln Riley calling a terrific game.
He really is. Kasatati, the right guard. Samia, the right tackle. Both with 2 blocks to spring Perine loose, but it was the formation and moving the safeties and linebackers out of position that really opened that up.
Armstrong again drives the kick deep, and Chris Platt's going to bring it out. Knocked down across the 15. ESPN's got you covered tomorrow morning. NFL Insiders Sunday edition at 10 Eastern. Sunday NFL Countdown with Boomer and the Gang at 11. Also on the Watch ESPN app. So now Kirk, Jared Stidham, second start of his career, the first one at home in this big showcase game, facing a 2-touchdown deficit.
Composure. Art Briles has been here. He understands. You just got to keep sticking to the game plan and doing what you do. The blink of an eye, they can get back into this game. But they've got to start to challenge their offensive line to start winning some battles up front, because they've been losing to that defensive line.
First down run again. It's Chafin, who's wrestled down by Zach Chance, Zach Sanchez. Now Stidham's had a couple of big plays. Got off to a slow start. Obviously, the big 34-yarder in the last touchdown drive to Coleman was key. And the Bears just not in that rhythm, not playing with their usual tempo, are they?
Not at all.
An offense that snaps it every 16 or 17 seconds. Stidham breaks free and then slides down across the 20. It'll be a third down and a long 4.
There's an example again. There's just nowhere to go with a football. You've got underneath routes getting in this area right here, and look at the Sooners in coverage. You're a freshman quarterback. Where are you going to go with the football? Great coverage again by the Sooners.
They try the middle. Nowhere to run. Chafin is stacked up. Oklahoma defenders getting stirred up. It's a 4th 3-and-out for Baylor.
There's a star in the making in Charles Walker. You know how many great defensive linemen we've seen over the years in Norman? Charles Walker doesn't get the attention because of Tapper and some of the others. But right off the edge, 97. It gets extension, uses his quickness and speed to go right by Pat Colbert, a senior. And you're talking about Walker as a sophomore at 6'2 and 300 pounds out of Garland, Texas. A great athlete up front.
Art Biles likes to use the tennis term that I feel like I helped introduce, service breaks. Bears are having their service broken left and right here tonight. And Oklahoma now a chance to really take a commanding lead if they can find the end zone again midway in the third quarter. The Allstate bus has joined us down here in Waco. You can enter the Allstate It's Good sweepstakes. Chance to win $100,000 plus a VIP trip to the Allstate Sugar Bowl and the national championship game, as well as weekly prizes.
What you just said is big in a game like this that can go potentially back and forth. A couple big stops. Oklahoma has been gaining momentum and confidence. It's a team that they've been embarrassed by the last 2 years. This is a huge possession, the way this game is going, for this Baylor defense and for the Sooner offense.
It's Beeline as they try to tenderize that shorthanded defensive line. Heather?
Chris, the injuries for the Baylor defense continue to mount. Now, starting safety Chance Waz just went into the locker room. He has got a left shoulder injury. They're evaluating it. Right now, they're recalling his return doubtful. Remember, last week he had a neck strain. Right now, that same area being evaluated, Chris.
Yeah, Waz, your eye was knocked out of the Kansas State game. A hit from his teammate, Stewart, who Heather also said is playing hurt. Well, you're right, Kirk. There's some urgency for this Baylor defense. Yes. It's used to playing with the lead and protecting the lead. And now a bunch of guys out, a bunch of guys hurting.
Phil Bennett. Phil Bennett's doing everything he can. He's had to move some people around even when he came in tonight. 56, KJ Smith is a, he's holding his thumb, Oakman, but he's a defensive end. They've had to move him down to play defensive tackle some.
This would be big for the Bears if they could get off the field here on 3rd and 4. Mayfield escapes. Gonna make the first down and more. Another scramble from the Oklahoma quarterback down near the 35.
Tell you what, man, this kid has got something special. This kid is special. Third down, you're gonna play man to man. He's got mobility, he's got feel. He recognizes it, takes off, and picks up the first down.
Piron hammers ahead and escapes and is tackled at just as he was trying to get momentum by Sells.
Well, I thought he might pull out of that. It looked, Chris, I thought he looked like he was down. This guy has such balance. Watch him run, low center of gravity, somehow sneaks out of there. And if it were not for the effort by Sells, he's into the end zone again.
Watch some of his runs this year. I think this guy's got tremendous flexibility.
You're right.
For a really powerful guy. That helps him.
He's become such a more complete back, though. He's more agile. He's got more lateral movement. Last year, he was a bull.
Mayfield loops the ball for Shepard. Far side, out of bounds, overthrown. Lincoln Riley going for blood right now. This is Baylor-like what they're doing, isn't it?
I think we're all sensing how big a possession this is, whether it's Lincoln Riley down there calling these plays or the viewers or you and I. This is a crucial point in this football game.
Another third down. Bears are showing pressure.
Now remember, when they've showed this blitz, he has an opportunity to be able to try to get the football right here to Sterling Shepard.
Mayfield instead takes a shot far side. Jump ball broken up. Ron Neal very well defended. That was a terrific play by Ryan Reed, who's a backup corner.
He has been a starter in the past, and he is stride for stride here. Does a good job. That is textbook right there by Reed. He sensed the hands and the eyes of Neal, and that's when he threw his arm off to knock that football away. Great play.
Oklahoma going for it here on fourth and five.
Baylor brought pressure the last play, Chris. Let's see if they bring pressure again and create those one-on-one matchups.
Huge play. Mayfield, screen, Shepard, cannot escape. Brought down, and Baylor makes a stand. 11th catch for Shepard, but couldn't escape Terrell Burt, and the Bears take over.
Well, that's, you know, Burt's involved, but the guy who made the play is Trevon Blanchard by getting around the block, potential block of Mark Andrews. It's a big-time stop here by Baylor. Watch 48 off to the side here. Does a good job of working around right there. Watch it, works around. Andrews gets involved, forces it back inside, and that's where Burt and the rest of the Baylor defenders were. But we talked about how important that possession was before it started. They got the stop, and now you see what Baylor can do here offensively.
Can they find some rhythm with this true freshman quarterback? Play action on first down. Nowhere to throw the ball. Sidham backpedals and now just chucks it into the Oklahoma bench. Again, great coverage.
Yeah, seven guys in pass coverage. Mike Stoops, I know he's upstairs looking down watching this. This plan that was put together is working up to this point, and it has everything to do with keeping people in coverage and dominating the line of scrimmage with a great defensive line.
Coleman is to the left of the formation.
Chris, usually you have to commit numbers against Shaq Linwood in the running game, and it leaves you vulnerable in one-on-one opportunities in the pass game.
Play action, they flip it across the middle, catch made, blow delivered, and still running is Gus Penning, the tight end with a huge play down to the 30. As Bryles dials up a little deception.
And he came right out of the backfield, right here. He looks like he's gonna lead block, and then actually just sneaks behind the linebacker, Alexander. The ball had to be thrown in a hurry because of the safety that Ahmad Thomas coming in so quickly, and that's exactly what he does. He reads it, feels it, gets the ball thrown in a hurry.
It was only
physical
Penning's
tackle there.
Yeah, only Penning's fifth catch of the season. You can see the volatile Mr. Stoops, who's much calmer in the booth than he is in the sidelines, looking down as Penning is attended to and now helped to his feet. 250-pounder. Comes from Michigan. Not many guys in this Baylor roster from outside of the state of Texas.
He is a big target, 6'6", 250.
They're pretty good wheels after the catch, didn't
they? Yeah,
a lot of space, but
ran over Ahmad Thomas and then did show some speed. Gotta love how Baylor just kind of keeps pecking. They keep looking, they keep trying to find it. It's not working in the run game. Coleman's not necessarily working. They decide to go to Gus Penning, who has four receptions on the year. Sneak him out of the backfield. They just keep trying to find a weakness in your defense.
Big Laquan McGowan, number 80, is lined up in the backfield. 39-yard gain sets him up on first down. Sit him with a pump fake. The end zone. Jay Lee is wide open and dropped it. Right off the hands of the senior receiver. Should have been seven.
A stutter and go on an island against Zach Sanchez, and he had him. He gave him a little stop and go. And right through his hands off the face mask. But Zach Sanchez, who's a little bit of a guesser, jumped the route early, and it was very easy for Lee to get around him. He just dropped the ball.
Linwood runs forward. And again, when you're trying to make up a 14-point deficit, drops like that amplify the importance if Baylor can't find the end zone on this drive. That'll be one they'll remember. Quarterback soon.
This is third down, but obviously four down territory.
Linwood chased down by Stryker for a loss. Eric Stryker makes his first big play of the night. Not just a sack master.
And you have Stryker involved. You also have the middle linebacker, Jordan Evans. Here's Stryker. He's going to attack. He sees the formation. There's not a tight end there. It allows him to collapse in a hurry. Shock Linwood never had a chance with that closing speed of Eric Striker.
Makes this fourth down play a little more complicated. They now need 8 yards after the loss. Stidham on a slant. Cannon makes a catch inside the five. First and goal. Clutch for Kenny Cannon. And the quarterback.
The middle of the field is wide open. Watch the ball, and there's the arm strength that we've talked all week about from Jarrett Stidham.
Bears wanted to play fast, but a Sooner is down on the field. Another look at the catch.
And look at the arm strength. That ball is thrown, as we say, on a rope there between the safeties, behind the linebackers. This is where they like to attack. They get their speed out in space. They love to come into the middle behind those linebackers. Here's his arm strength. It's that tight spiral we've seen from him.
It's Charles Tapper, who's down for the Sooners, star defensive lineman, but Stidham's been clutch. They had the 3rd and 14. They got the big gain in the last touchdown drive, 23 yards on that 4th and 8.
For a young guy, he does come across as almost unflappable as far as the pressure. It doesn't ever seem too much for him.
You said it well, though, yesterday as Tapper has helped up. It was so easy for him, almost effortless in his first start, a tough environment. But listen, for any quarterback, much less a true freshman, you're going to have those nights where suddenly it's not going to feel as easy as effortless, and you have to work through it.
No, and we were watching him in practice. He's loose. He's confident. He's been here since January. And rolls out in Manhattan, Kansas, throws 3 touchdowns, over 400 yards, and kind of a walk in the park. You knew tonight against this Sooner defense would be more challenging, but you got to be impressed with the young guy and the way he's just kind of hung in there, and he's given his team still a chance to compete to try to get back in this game.
So first and goal, the big truck. McGowan, number 80, shifting around. He's on the left end as an extra offensive lineman slash tight end. And now a timeout taken by Oklahoma. Baylor tries to cut into this lead when you come back. Baylor Bears used to pretty easy victories. Nothing easy about this one. They still face a 14-point deficit, but have a first and goal at the 5.
They have been physical when they've had their chances tonight inside that 5-yard line. Devin Chafin, usually 28, has been in there, their power back.
Both teams, Kirk, have been perfect in the red zone, each 3 for 3 with touchdowns.
What do you think? Throw to the big fella, McGowan? Big 80.
He's got great hands, very soft hands. He's in the left side in the tight end position. Chafin already with 3 touchdowns. They fake it to him. Throw to the big fella. 410-pound touchdown. Eyebrows and a twinkle in his eyes. And come on, he can involve the big fella. So you might see something.
That's what I thought. If there's ever a time to see it. First and goal. The big 400-pound tight end. You got to get him the ball. The only other time he's had a chance was in last year's bowl game against Michigan State. We saw him in practice. We were mesmerized by how soft his hands were, catching balls one-handed.
He's a terrific story, too. He wanted to be an NBA star growing up, kind of outgrew that. Went to high school at a boys' ranch, which he actually asked for. Gave him discipline, direction in his life, and you can see the talent. Soft hands, good feet for a big fella, a huge fella.
And it's actually a really good call because they're not anticipating him sneaking in behind. They're thinking that Chapin's going to run the ball. So he just does a nice job there. Just shows a little bit to Devontae Bond right here. Just gets his hands up and then just comes off of him. Stidham gives him a little time, has the patience there to be able to get him. Takes a little bit of time for 400 pounds to get around.
you know when you score a touchdown, you try to lift up the guy that scores? Are you kidding me? They tried to.
Who's trying to lift him up?
They tried to lift a whole.
Oh! Durango got him up!
Heather, what do you got?
Hey, guys.
Laquan McGowan is large, as you guys talked about. He wears a size 21 shoe, but during games, he squeezes into a petite size 18. He says even though his toes are pinched, it helps him run faster, and that his correct shoe size feels too heavy on the field. And when you're younger, imagine trying to find a size 21 shoe. He was competing in sports, asked the Dallas Mavericks for help, asked the Cowboys for help. They didn't have shoes big enough, so Shaquille O'Neal sent him shoes when he was playing for the Phoenix Suns, so he'd have some shoes big enough.
Kick goal bounce out of bounds. All he does is score touchdowns, Kirk. Three career receptions, three touchdowns for Big Laquan. Let's go to Cassidy Hubbard for an update from the studio.
Thanks, Chris. Taco Bell studio update. Houston came back from being down 20. Memphis with a chance to retake the lead, but Jake Elliott misses the 48-yard field goal. Houston survives to stay unbeaten. Meanwhile, Stanford needed a two-point conversion for the tie with seconds left, and Kevin Hogan, incomplete pass. Oregon upsets Stanford 38-36. Chris, hurry back to you.
Wow, what a huge win for Helfrich and the Ducks, and that's obviously a critical loss for Stanford's playoff chances and probably for the whole conference's chances.
As I said this morning, if Stanford were to lose tonight, get outscored by Oregon, that could really crush the Pac-12 and their chances of getting into that top four the remainder of the way.
Utah, I suppose, only the glimmer of hope from that league. So the Sooners up only seven now. Hand it to Perine, who breaks another tackle, gives another stiff arm, and makes another good first down gain. Now, here's a flag. A helmet was ripped off one of the defensive linemen. That was Billings who lost the hat. I don't think it came off on its own.
Well, there were two guys just swinging at each other. Jonathan Alvarez, the left guard, and you said Billings. Well, they were going after each other.
Reggie Smith trying to sort things out there with his crew. They've had their hands full tonight. Been a hot-tempered game. Mental mistakes
after
on both sides.
Personal foul, hands to the face. Offense number 68. Caused number 75's helmet to come off. 15-yard penalty from the dead ball spot. It's second down. Number 75 may remain in the game.
Jonathan Alvarez guilty of the penalty. Mental mark it back 15 yards. Wow, again, a penalty, which is just kind of a guy losing his composure. It's been typically the big guys down in the pit who've done so. That is a crucial penalty that puts the Sooners way behind the chains as the rain begins to fall again. Mayfield rolling out. Under pressure, just throws it away. Blanchard is at a big night, was given chase. Third and 20.
He tried some misdirection with that fast-flowing Baylor defense. The Bears in that speed able to chase Mayfield down, and now after that huge mistake by Alvarez, probably just run the football here and try to avoid a mistake.
Energy is back in McLean Stadium, big time. They do hand it to Perine. He's got a squadron of blockers, but the Bears defense knifes through. That was Edwards and Blanchard combining. Oklahoma will have to punt.
You're right. You can feel a different energy in here right now after the touchdown. And now they get a three and out to get the ball right back to Jared Stidham and his Baylor offense.
But again, that major penalty just really killing that drive. Seibert, an excellent punter. Not one of his better efforts. Hawthorne comes up, bobbled it, tried to make the fair catch. It bounced back into his hands. Now they'll wrestle for it at the 32-yard line. Still trying to sort out who has the football. Baylor's going to keep it. As Hawthorne dodges what would have been a huge mistake. He said the rain has come back. Oh, ball wet again.
Got his legs there to help him.
How lucky was that?
Yeah, if he didn't have his legs and his knees to help him, I think that ball bounces on the ground right into the hands of Jordan Thomas.
Absolutely.
Jeez.
A knee catch. The elements, once again, perhaps a factor. We thought the rain would move out. That's what the forecast called for. It stopped for a while.
coming down again, and the wind kicking up as well.
Still a long way to go in this football game with the way these two teams potentially could move the ball.
Linwood, there's some hesitation. Zidane wanted to pull the ball. Linwood didn't want to give it up. And the quarterback keeps it for a short gain.
That's a zone read play with a quarterback and the running back. Remember, they're not sure who's going to get it depending on what the defensive lineman does. And Walker doesn't really commit. So you got Linwood saying, you better take it. And you got Stidham saying, you better take it. You're lucky to get back to the line of scrimmage.
Now Stidham fires. Intercepted. Zach Sanchez has got it. Weaving his way down inside the 30. A miscommunication between receiver and quarterback, and Sanchez makes a big play.
That's exactly right. KD Cannon not on the same page with the young freshman Stidham. And in this offense, this is about timing, and Stidham gets the ball out. He read a certain coverage. There's a lot of adjustments to coverage. Cannon didn't even know the ball was thrown. He runs a quick slant. And Stidham expecting something else because of the coverage that he saw. You can see the ball is thrown. Cannon has no idea. Part of Baylor's offense, again, is the receivers and the quarterback being on the same page and reading the coverage together. Here, the receiver read one coverage. The quarterback read another, not on the same page, and Sanchez is waiting for that interception.
It's his fourth pick of the year. He's been nursing an ankle trouble. You can see at the end of a play as ankles kind of got rolled up. The alpha of that secondary sets the Sooners up at the 28. And Mayfield wants to take a shot on first down. Loops it downfield. Shepard makes the catch down to the 12-yard line.
But that is a
and he's
big,
now slow to get up.
That's a big arm. You're throwing that in the college game from the left hash all the way to the sideline. And he throws it again on a rope with a safety that time. Burt has no chance to come over and make a play on the football.
Two-back look on first down. Low snap. And that play didn't work from the start. Mixon has dropped for a loss, but the timing thrown off by the snap. Again, this Baylor defense trying to come up with a stop. Final minute of the third quarter.
You're right. That had a weird feel from the beginning here. They really didn't have much of a chance. Baylor all over it with the timing. You're right, because of the snap off.
Young made the tackle for a loss of 3 yards. Second down, clock at 15 seconds in the third quarter. Rain picking up even more now. Mixon tries to make the edge. Cannot hit hard. Another loss. Consecutive losses as Jamal Palmer came up to hit the running back. And tempers flare again. Mixon lost his helmet.
This defense is flying around right now. How about Sells, Chris? How physical he is stepping in for Stewart.
Well, Oklahoma threatening, up 7 as the rain falls in Waco. A hot-blooded, hard-hitting, surprisingly defensive game. Back for the final quarter after this message and a word from your local ABC station. Water resistant. Be awarded to the winner, of course, January 11th in Glendale, Arizona. Baylor still bothered. They weren't given a chance to compete for that trophy last year. Trying to make their playoff case with a win tonight. But Oklahoma trying to build the lead as we begin the final quarter. Third and 14. They got to get down to about the 2-yard line. Empty backfield. Bears back out. Rush only 3. Mayfield looking for somebody. Still looking. Fires. End zone. Broken up. Tried to get it to Mark Andrews, who's had a couple of opportunities. He's holding his left arm. Wells was in coverage. It's fourth down.
Mayfield did everything he could to keep this play alive and eventually finds Andrews, who has a chance here. It's the second time tonight.
Yep.
We've seen the young freshman have a chance to make a critical play. That's a beautiful view of it right there. But unable again to squeeze the ball for a first down, maybe a touchdown there.
He's been a reliable target with 6 touchdown catches. So instead, Seibert from 33 to make it a 10-point game. And he knocks it through.
So Baylor, 13 seconds into the final quarter, once again down by double digits. Pacific Life game summary as we begin the fourth quarter here. Each team with a couple of touchdowns in the third quarter. Shepherd having a monster evening for Oklahoma. 12 receptions approaching the single game Oklahoma record, which is 15. He's got a piece of that record.
He's trying to make up for the last two games against Baylor in one night. Trying to put three into one.
Thompson to boot it away. Sooners will work into the wind here in the final quarter. And this kick will not reach the end zone. And Ishmael Zamora has a chance and gets a couple blocks. Zamora runs by the kicker to midfield and knocked down inside Oklahoma territory by Stephen Parker. But a big play from the special team sets up Baylor.
Boy, what a great job. And, you know, the coaches told us about Zamora and his big play ability as a wide receiver. And he is a big, rangy guy as a freshman. It's 6'4", 220. And I tell you, the kicker just slowing him down just enough allowed Stephen Parker to eventually catch up to him. But that was just great blocking and hitting the crease and having some natural ability in that speed at 6'4".
Zamora with a 58-yard return. And now Stidham set up with the 39, I should say. And feeds it off to Linwood, who's wrestled down. Jordan Evans came flying into the backfield.
And that reoccurring theme with Oklahoma's defensive line and linebackers doing a very good job on early downs of pinning their ears and attacking that offensive line, that veteran offensive line, getting off of blocks and getting into the backfield.
Linwood on second and long. Hesitates, he'll be dropped. You just don't see Baylor lose yards like this.
I mean, you're talking about a back that averages 8 yards a carry and a team that averages over 300 yards rushing, and it's been tough sledding up there. This is another example. Look at the extension. Look at the linebackers closing, linemen getting off of blocks, and they're just chasing him down.
Two runs, lose 5 yards, and now Stidham facing third and 15.
And I don't care how good a freshman quarterback you are in this, and what, how good this offensive scheme is, third and long like this is tough.
Play action, Stidham hit at the 50 and slammed down by Tapper. What a stand by the Sooners defense after the big kick return set the Bears up.
Well, Charles Tapper is in a sprinter stance. You know, he's had 5 sacks in the last 2 games coming into tonight, and there's nothing that Stidham could have done here. Watch the speed rush right here. Watch how quick Tapper gets by this offensive line. Kyle Fuller, one of the better linemen up front, just cannot deal with the leverage, the speed of Charles Tapper that time. As I said, third and long, you know what's going to happen. And Tapper pinned his ears back and just put that speed rush on him.
I figured, Kirk, no way in that series are they going to ever punt the ball. But Stidham was hurt on that sack. And on fourth and 21, Riles, as much as he hates, has to punt it away. Covert seemed as a great job. They hustled down. And that was Patrick Levels just dropping the ball at the 1-yard line. So the Sooners up by 10. Will start from the 1 as pylon cam shows you this nifty special teams play.
Saturday Night Football presented by Walmart, brought to you by Pacific Life. For life insurance, annuities, and investments, choose Pacific Life, the power to help you succeed. K Jewelers, who would like to remind you that right now, it's engagement season. And AT&T, mobilizing your world.
Everything Goodyear has learned, making tires that go the distance inspires where they roll into yours. Goodyear, more driven, the official aerial provider of Saturday Night Football. Jared Stidham in obvious pain, trying to grit his teeth, not let his teammates see it after that sack by Tapper. Oklahoma takes over at the 3. They spot it there. That's where Levels first touch the ball, covering it. But here's Big Tapper hammering the freshman, who, again, he's getting a taste of what college football is about. You can see him grimace right away. They don't really have any experience at all
behind him. Chris Johnson's a sophomore that's not attempted a pass, and Reed's got to try to grit his teeth and hang in there. There's Seth Russell, the opening day starter, who was injured. And second down, Mixon hammers forward across the 10. It'll be third down. Kendall Briles visiting with Stidham. Seems to be okay.
Make sure he's ready to go back out there, clear his mind, and get ready to play football.
Meanwhile, Mayfield chased around on third down, barely stays out of the end zone. They rip at the football and drop him at the one. Jamal Palmer, and again, Trevon Blanchard in there.
Yeah, Blanchard's had a heck of a night for this Bears defense, and I gotta love Phil Bennett's mentality. He's got to pin back. Let's pin our ears back ourselves. We've seen Oklahoma doing that a lot. I think we've called Jamal Palmer and Trevon Blanchard's name more than anybody else on this defense tonight. They've been out on the edge. They've been blitzing from the outside, making plays against this very talented Oklahoma offense all night.
No, you're
but
right.
Phil Bennett doing a heck of a job staying aggressive.
Both three long, athletic guys. Blanchard had the pick earlier. Seibert backed up in his end zone. And this very, very good freshman punter drives them back to the 45-yard line. So Jared Stidham gritting his teeth, back to work with good field position as the Bears, with 11:01 to play, try to cut into this lead.
Remember, the Bears had the big kickoff return, looked like they had some momentum, and then of course they end up having to punt. How important is special teams? They punted inside the 5-yard line, the Sooners go three and out, and now Stidham, even after the sack and the disappointment, they get the ball right back in plus territory, still only down 10 with 11 minutes to go in this game.
Stidham gained 28 pounds since he arrived Baylor as an early enrollee. He was a skinny kid in high school. He's been rooming with two offensive linemen, including Spencer Durango. So maybe hanging up the O-line has helped him bulk up and survive hits like that last one. The first down throw far side. It's low, and Jay Lee couldn't come up with it.
You know, we showed him grimacing. We showed him with a coat on with all the rain. We showed Kendall Briles talking to him, Seth Russell talking to him. The one thing we didn't see was him throwing. I was surprised. That's the first ball that he has thrown since he came off after he got body slammed by Charles Tapper, and that was not like him, the throw that he just made right there, as far as his accuracy and velocity.
Here's a second throw. The downfield shot coming back for the ball. This Cannon, and he's wrestled out for the first down. Two Sooner defenders, Kirk, but he didn't really spy the ball.
Well, Parker never finds the football, and Cannon does a good job of coming back to the ball. It's a bit underthrown. See, the can see Parker's just lost in one-on-one coverage, and that's the matchup. Who's going to win those matchups on the outside? Give KD Cannon there.
They got 27, and now Stidham tries to escape again. Loops the ball for the end zone. Two receivers come to the area, and it's caught by Lee for a touchdown. Cannon, meanwhile, the second receiver who almost collided with Lee, is down in the corner of the end zone. Not how they drew it up, but they'll take it.
Right. Anytime you see two receivers in the same area almost crash into each other, there's a mistake. But you're right. See Lee coming out, and right there, the ball's thrown to Lee. How Cannon got involved, I think he started to improvise a bit. That ball is thrown right over the shoulder. Sooners defense confused there.
Jordan Evans for Oklahoma was also hurt on the play. Cannon off from walking to the sidelines, but what a gritty drive for this quarterback. An obvious pain, comes out, uses the field position, and now Baylor, a PAT away from making this a three-point game. These have not been automatic tonight. Callahan into the hole, Cole Edmondson. No problem that time. Tough guy quarterback showing his grit as the Bears fight back at home. Three-point game in Waco. A soaked but suddenly much happier crowd here in Waco, jumping around on the timeout, trying to give the Bears some energy. A three-point game, that guys in the sidelines doing the same. I remember seeing that sign over the years when the Bears were
underdogs and pulled off surprises, coming in as favorites tonight over Oklahoma. And their hands full. Evans with a breeze in his back, boots it to Ross, who will bring it out. Alex Ross, straight up the middle, dragged down at the 23. Our LG V10 moments of the day. Two unbeaten teams had to rally in the fourth quarter to stay unbeaten. Oklahoma State was down 17 at Iowa State. Came back to win by four, outscoring the Cyclones 14-0. Sets up the potential showdown at home next week against Baylor. Michigan, a late touchdown to force overtime, won it in double overtime in Bloomington. And Houston, they were down by 20 to Memphis in the fourth quarter, won 35-34 with a big rally late as the Cougars stay unbeaten. And Oregon knocking off Stanford on the road, ending the Cardinal playoff hopes. Mixon. Bears string him out, dropping for a loss.
You saw Sean Oakman get penetration to slow Mixon down. But how about the rest of this defense? Anticipating run and beating Mixon to the corner there. They tried to outflank him. There's just nowhere to go. Watch the speed of this defense. Oakman gets some penetration, slows him down. But look at the outside there. Look at all those black jerseys.
Trevon Blanchard again just selling out with effort on that play. Mayfield rolling, chased, throws it into the benches. He's dropped, a flag comes in. Blanchard was pressuring him, so was Palmer. Mayfield slow to get up.
Personal foul, horse collar tackle, defense number 48. 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Actually, it wasn't a tackle. He did grab the horse collar of Mayfield, and that's Blanchard there as he was throwing the ball away.
Blanchard again with that speed, but right there with the right hand, pulls the back of that jersey, right in front of the referee.
Such a potential for injury and a tackle like this. Pull backward, you could see Mayfield grab his leg after the tackle.
He's looking at the ankle or the knee. He's up, though, and ready to play the next down.
Improves the field position up to the 32. Mayfield still easy. Now both quarterbacks are trying to play through some pain. Now it's Burt, Terrell Burt, the safety, just in the secondary on his back.
That was a called injury by Baylor's Ryan Reed, number 9. He told Burt, "You're supposed to be hurt. Go down." I've never seen anything like that in my life. Watch this. He actually go. Hey, go. No, you're hurt. You're down. Oh, okay, man. I got you. What? What are we doing here? What are we doing?
Hey, did you say that's a called injury?
Yeah. It's like, oh, yo. You're down. You're down. That is
awful. I'm not sure that actually even helps the defense at that point. I mean, Mayfield was hurting himself.
Now he's going to fake a limp? I mean, that is Bush League. I don't get that.
That's the kind of thing that you like to criticize soccer, one of my favorite sports, for that kind of acting job.
No, but I mean, this football, that's unethical. You don't do that. That's awful. Now he's gonna fake it all the way through and then hustle back out, play or two later.
Was he possibly hurt, then got up and tried to get off?
No, he was ready to play.
Well, they're carrying through this thing. They're continuing the
charade.
First down. Mayfield had time, escapes, has a lot of room. Mayfield shaking, diving to midfield. He is ripping his arm. Both quarterbacks just battling through some pain, but they move the chains again.
Again, man-to-man coverage with an athletic quarterback. You've got to be very careful. If you're not going to spy him with a linebacker, he's going to have a lot of room to run. In fact, we've seen Baker Mayfield tonight recognize that man under coverage and take off and run and pick up big yards.
He's got those rubber pellets that are in the field. They're all over his face, his face mask. He didn't care. He, Ryan, muscles forward for just a few. You know, you talk about this conference, Kirk, and
Now it's all about finesse, and they didn't really hit or tackle or play defense. We were seeing the opposite of that tonight.
Oh, without a doubt. If people have not seen a lot of Big 12 football, they have to be appreciating the contact, physicality, the way these teams are playing on both sides of the football. Yeah, you're seeing some points, but you're seeing two defenses flying around and make some plays, too.
And you're seeing two defenses that are really going to be under stress, aren't they, in the final 9 minutes, because both offenses have begun to crank it up and run lots of snaps. Play action on second down. Mayfield has time. Can he find a receiver? Flips it complete. First down at the 40-yard line. That's Dede Westbrook. He took a shot at the end of the play.
What he did there is he was trying to get the ball to his main man tonight. Throwing the ball to Sterling Shepard, but he's taken away. Watch him come off of him in the middle. Shows the patience, and then eventually Dede Westbrook breaks free. Good job of improvising there by Westbrook, and a nice job by Mayfield of seeing him.
Yeah, good toughness. The receiver had to know he was going to take a big shot after that catch. Herine hammers ahead. Down by the ankle, but he's got a first down inside the 30. It was Singleton saving a touchdown.
Yeah, he follows Orlando Brown, the freshman, left tackle, and Jonathan Alvarez. Watch the two big fellas lead the way on a counter play. Opens it up, and again, he's got its acceleration for his size at 230.
157 yards for Piron. There's another first down run. Hard earned yard.
Baylor linebackers and safety starting to really get involved in the run game. Doing everything they can to try to slow down Samaje Perine. It's a battle of wills with 7 minutes to go here.
Sure,
a three-point game.
Sooners using some play clock here. Second down throw. Near side. Catch made. Shepard out of bounds. First and goal, Oklahoma.
It's one-on-one matchup. Sterling Shepard matched up against a safety, Singleton, who is in this football game right now. Look at the cushion that Singleton gives Shepard because of the appreciation and respect of how he can get by him vertically. But a mismatch when you have your best receiver and the quickest receiver up against a backup safety. And that time, Baker Mayfield was able to locate him and make a nice throw.
Targeted 15 times. He's made 13 catches. He goes out now. Andrews, the freshman, has had a tough night. Back in the game to the right of the formation. And the clock was running down. And Oklahoma has to spend its second timeout. Stoops frustrated. Did not want to get back to 5 yards there, that's for sure. Bob wants this one tonight.
Yeah, he's got a little bit of fire going tonight.
He sure did. In the pregame warm-up, he was extra involved. He would love to throw the headset, but he can't see the head, the visor and the hood. And let me throw that thing. Can I? Let me, yeah. All tangled up. So they did not get the timeout. That's why I was frustrated. It was a delay. So first and goal, they sling it far side. Mixon cannot break a tackle. Muscled out by Blanchard again.
Talk about a difference in what may transpire here in these next two or three plays, Chris. Under 6 minutes to go. You kick a field goal, you go up by six, and you get Baylor the ball. You score a touchdown, you go up by 10, and it's a two-possession game. These next two or three plays are vitally important.
Obey that five-yard penalty, such a source of fury for Stoops. Fake it to Mixon. Mayfield on the run. Keeps it knocked out inside the 10. So it'll be third and goal. They'll spot the ball down at the 7.
We've seen Sterling Shepard in some of these red zone areas check out of the game for the larger Mark Andrews at 6'5". And looks like Andrews will come back into the game. But this time, you're going to see Sterling Shepard stay in the game.
He'll be lined up in the slot. There's Andrews.
Third and goal. Another huge play.
Bob Stoops calling a timeout. He was kind of working the sideline, prowling towards the official. I couldn't tell if he was going to make the call or not.
Now what will the Sooners call? Third and goal coming up next. Baylor defense has lost three starters to injury tonight. Orion Stewart and Chance Waz, both safeties, and Bo Blackshear trying to dig in deep, Kirk, on third and goal.
Oklahoma comes out in the exact same formation where they have the taller receiver Andrews and also Shepard right here in the slot.
Erine is the back. Bears rush only three. Mayfield looking, scrambling, retreating, fires to the end zone for a touchdown to Flowers. Extending the play, showing patience, and look at Trevor Knight, last year's starter, off to celebrate with Mayfield there.
That play is kind of symbolic of the night and the season that Baker Mayfield has had for this Oklahoma Sooners offense. You thought he might give up on the play. You thought he might throw it away. But his H-back, who was in blocking, Flowers, talk about Mayfield's going to get the credit. But Dimitri Flowers was blocking. He wasn't even going out for a pass. And he turned around and figured out, keep your eye on this guy right here. And this play takes a long time, but he is in blocking, waiting. You think he might run, and then he decides right here to take off and try to get out into the open field. I can't believe none of the linemen went downfield. In fact, the freshman, Samia, the right tackle, actually did. The right tackle, 75 from Oklahoma. He's almost near the goal line.
You can't blame him. Mayfield was failing for 15 seconds back there. But Flowers has made two catches tonight, both of them huge, one setting up a touchdown, and now that touchdown gives Oklahoma a 10-point lead inside of 5 minutes to go, and may have been their crucial play to help the Sooners get some payback against Baylor.
I cannot say enough about Baker Mayfield, the energy, the heart that he possesses, and how his team feeds off of him.
Remember, he made the mistake to Blanchard and had the report. He went right away to the offensive line and took ownership of the mistake. He said, guys, hang with me. I'm going to make up for that. And he's played beautifully since that mistake.
Yeah, without a doubt. I mean, this whole offense has done such a remarkable job since the game in Texas against the Longhorns, where they lost and had a miserable day offensively.
I'm just wondering, they couldn't find a scholarship for him in Lubbock?
No doubt.
I'm just saying. This plaque gets the edge and gets knocked down at the 30-yard line. So Baylor's got to show serious urgency. Over on ESPN tonight, after the Wazoo UCLA game, stick around for SportsCenter at night. Recap of another eventful Saturday in college football. SportsCenter at night also streams live on the Watch ESPN app.
Remember, you're talking about a Baylor offense that specializes in scoring in under 2 minutes. I mean, they can score in a hurry, and that's exactly what it's going to take right here from Stidham and his group of wide receivers to make some big plays, something that's been tough for them to do against his center secondary.
Stidham, downfield, intercepted. Tried to take a shot. Ahmad Thomas came across and made the catch, and that might do it for Oklahoma. This secondary given so much abuse and grief, so embarrassed at the last two meetings. How sweet is this celebration?
Well, it's an amazing way to potentially wrap this up. Mike Stoops deserves a ton of credit. He's taken so much heat in Norman for the way his defense has performed in some of these bigger games, giving up a lot of points, giving up a lot of plays. They put a plan together, and his players went out and executed it tonight. Ahmad Thomas in the middle of your field. He actually does a good job of reading the eyes of the young freshman quarterback who stared down Jay Lee. One of the few times we've seen him make a mistake, show his youth. He stared Jay Lee down, and Ahmad Thomas, the junior from Miami, read it and jumped it and comes up with maybe the play of the game.
Third turnover for the Bears, who are minus two in that department. They were plus 11 coming in here on short gain. Again, look at the last couple years. Rush yards, 377. Pass yards last year. They got ripped up on the ground a couple of years ago. Didn't have a takeaway in either game, Kirk, in three tonight.
Yeah, I think that's the difference. I mean, you can see there's still some points being scored, but when you defend Baylor, I got news for you. I don't care who you are. You're going to give up some points when you try to slow these guys down. And I think there was a different plan. There was a different level of confidence in the secondary tonight from Oklahoma and on the defensive line. I mean, those are the two areas. When you look at them the last 2 years on film and you look at them this year, totally different group of athletes on that defensive line, depth, and that secondary, they played their hearts out.
Now, we wondered, Oklahoma came from 17 down to win overtime in Knoxville, just failed to show up in Dallas. Everything went wrong against Texas. You wonder what's going on in Norman. There's no energy. There's no vitality. But Sterling Shepard told me they had a players-only meeting, a team meeting. They told the coaches, hey, we got to start practicing faster with more urgency, playing faster. And this team still had a lot to play for at that point. But we wondered, Kirk, with the last four games, they were blasting people. But how much of that was level of competition? How good really was this team? We're finding out tonight.
And that was only fair. It was only fair to look at how much they had improved from Texas and to wonder, you're right, is it because they're playing Texas Tech and Kansas and some of the others, or is it because they've actually improved? And I think so tonight, especially on the offense from where they were that night that they played in Dallas to where they are now. It's a totally different feel and different looking team.
Of course, in the Big 12, it was all going to be about the stretch run for all of these contenders. And Storman and Norman were calling it as TCU comes calling. Tremont Boykin had to leave the game, an ugly win over Kansas today with an ankle. We certainly hope he is okay. And then Baylor, if they don't come back here off their first loss, got to go regroup and play in Stillwater where they've had their problems over the years.
And Oklahoma State survived today in Ames and remain unbeaten. And remember, everybody has to go to Stillwater, all the contenders.
Baylor and TCU Friday after Thanksgiving, and then Bedlam, of course. Mayfield steps up, delivers. Shepard, one more catch. Shepard spins and knocks down at the 40-yard line. And Shepard within a catch now, equaling that school record for receptions in a game. He's got 14. Oklahoma not stepping off the gas up 10, are they?
And Sterling Shepard, a senior, a guy that probably could have come out last year. His father played for OU. The story is well documented, how he was around the locker room after his father passed away. Bob Stoops reached out to him when he was just a little guy. Yep. He grew up around the locker room, grew up loving the Sooners, and he's done everything he can these last two or three years. He's been disappointed at times, and trying to put it all together tonight has had a career night.
Pirine on first down. Shepard again knocked out in the first quarter a couple of years ago in a loss. Couldn't play at all last year. Was injured. Had a groin injury. Had to helplessly stand and watch his team get blown out at home. And you just sense every Oklahoma player we talked to, the eagerness, the energy, the anticipation for this game tonight. And it's played out.
Yeah, their pride was on the line. You know what I mean? They felt that, you know, all due respect to Baylor and what Baylor's done to them, a lot of these guys have lived it. And they felt that, hey, we still have a lot of pride as a program, and we're embarrassed by what's happened. And let's go to Waco and see if we're good enough to beat a really good team.
Pirine, short gain. Talked about since that Oklahoma game, this is going to be the fifth straight game the Sooners have gained 500 yards offense. Their streak of 50 plus points may be stopped, but this is an offense that's going to be very difficult for anybody to deal
with. Oh yeah, especially with Baker Mayfield, the way he's playing. And you know, we heard this week about Jason White, who won a Heisman Trophy, and Sam Bradford, who won a Heisman Trophy in Norman. And you start to look 9 or 10 games into a season, and you compare what Baker Mayfield has done to two guys that won the Heisman, and you start to look at his numbers.
Should he be in the mix, you think?
Absolutely.
In the conversation, because he has him, and he's been basically overlooked.
He should be.
I agree. This is the kind of game that can elevate you. Here's a keeper for the quarterback. Still running around and just slides on the red carpet for a first down. And they'll continue to chew on clock, and that could just about do it. Baylor with just one timeout.
Because what doesn't show up, and if you watch this game for four quarters and you watch this team play this year, they feed off of him. That's the difference. The intangibles, the heart, the fire. Again, I have not seen an Oklahoma quarterback in a long time that had such an impact on his team. So it's not just putting his stats next to these others. It's what he does to this team and how they feed off of his energy.
Very different kind of quarterback from Sam Bradford, who was a brilliant player. A little more cerebral, perhaps, not as fiery as
Absolutely. But Sam impacted his guys in a way, too. Maybe not with the fire, but we've seen the recognition tonight from this young man. He's made great throws. This was a touchdown earlier in the first half. I've been blown away to see his arm strength in person. And, of course, he has what it takes to improvise, create the mobility to be able to try to keep a play alive, the ability to extend plays. And this is the last touchdown. I mean, instead of giving up on it, he believes in his team and his players and his own athletic ability and comes up with big play after big play.
Bears are going to lose for the first time at McLean Stadium. They have been 10-0 here, average margin of 32 points in their 20-game home winning streak. Which goes back to Floyd Casey, snapped here. Ford wrap-up show with Cassidy Hubbard is coming up right after the game. As the Sooners are in victory formation, a very, very satisfying win on that level, but also a crucial one because Oklahoma, she ranks 12th by the selection committee. They could reshape things.
As we start to stack these one-loss teams, after what we've seen from Oklahoma since their loss to Texas, and with everybody that potentially they're going to start losing ahead of them, Oklahoma throws their hat into the ring with all those other one-loss teams. And they still have TCU and Bedlam with Oklahoma State in front of them.
Boomer Sooner comes to Waco and beats the Bears. Very different handshake last year when Soup suffered his worst home loss ever at the hands of Riles. Cursory and a handshake. Riles to Mayfield. Shepard, monster night, didn't quite get the record, fell one catch short. He didn't care about that. Down to Heather with Bob Stoops.
Chris, thanks so much, Coach. Congratulations. After 2 years of frustration against this team, what did your team show you tonight?
Played really well. They executed well both sides of the ball, came up with big plays. You know, played within ourselves and played a good game.
Your offense is an entirely different offense than it was even at the beginning of the season. How did it help you tonight?
But, you know, staying on the field, making big plays. Baker Mayfield, again, was incredible. And, you know, when you play Baylor, too, you've got to score, keep them on the bench and move the ball. And we were able to do that.
5 games ago, hard to believe, this very same team lost to Texas. Since then, what has changed about these Sooners?
Well, the execution overall has improved every week, and to come in here in their place and win here was another good win.
And let's talk about your brother and what his defense did for you guys, slowing down this very prolific Baylor offense. How did they do it?
Yeah, the entire defense was great. First, we controlled the run game after the first series. And then we covered them. We challenged them, our secondary. They did a great job covering, breaking to the ball, and challenging their receivers.
Coach, congrats on a great win.
Thank you.
Chris?
Well, the Oklahoma fans, Kirk, and the upper deck are hooping and hollering as the Sooners celebrate in the opposite corner. Bob Stoops, very, very satisfying win. This has to rank up for him in recent years.
This is a huge win for Bob Stoops. It's obviously a big win for the program. But Bob Stoops, you know, he has dealt with some things where fans and you know, media, people have kind of gone after them as a program and the Big Game Bob moniker that's been out there, and people have kind of taken some shots at him. So this was big for him and big for this team as they try to compete in 2015. But just in a broader sense for his legacy in showing people that Bob Stoops and Oklahoma still matter in the Big 12.
Big night for the defense, but the AT&T strong performance will focus on the three offensive stars for Oklahoma. Baker Mayfield threw for 270 and three touchdowns, ran for 76 yards and one. P. Ryan at a 166. Shepard again, 14 catches and two touchdowns. Back to Heather with Mayfield.
Thanks so much. Baker had incredible numbers, Chris. As you mentioned, also swiped the game ball here, has it tucked away in his helmet. He told me not to tell, but I had to bust on you, Baker. you think they're going to find out?
Yeah, they'll find out. Now you busted me.
What was the difference tonight? Back and forth, you threw a pick six early, and you gritted it out. What do you think was the X factor?
Just focusing in and doing our job. I mean, that interception's all my fault. If I'm going to miss anywhere on a pass, I got to miss outside, and that kid made a good play on it. And so I learned from my mistakes, and I was more aggressive from there.
I heard you go to your offense after that interception and tell them, you know, what you just said, it was my bad, it won't happen again. Where does that belief and that confidence come from?
I believe in my guys, and right now we have an incredible team. I believe in us, and I think we can go wherever we think we can. So, I'm proud of us. And so, I'm confident in us right now, and that's where it comes from.
What has changed about this offense and this overall team? Five games ago, we saw you guys lose. Now we see you guys just conquering the world out here with an incredible offense. What's been the difference?
I mean, we went into Texas, and we were kind of, we were focused about the atmosphere. I mean, we weren't focused about doing our job and the details. And that's what this whole offense is about. It's about doing your job down in and down out. And so when we do that, we're successful. And that's what we've been focusing on in the past weeks.
Congrats on the great win, Baker. Enjoy that game ball, too. Don't give it back. Chris.
Meanwhile, there's Stidham. Tough second start for this freshman who will have a big future.
Yeah.
Oklahoma, when you look at that Red River performance, it really is one of the outliers of the season. It's the one really good game that Texas has played all year. We wondered about Oklahoma, as you see Mike Stoops back in the press box celebrating. But now, Kirk, you have to really rethink Oklahoma as a playoff contender. Why not a one-loss team from this conference if the Sooners can take care of TCU and, as of now, unbeaten Oklahoma State?
Well, they're going to move up, obviously, this week in the rankings, and now they start to become, we said earlier, one of the teams of all the one-loss teams. The Texas loss will hurt them. If they get into the end of the year and it's a one-loss Notre Dame who took care of Texas and a one-loss Oklahoma, that could hurt them potentially. But the thing you have to remember is they beat Baylor and Waco, a good Baylor team. They still have a chance to play TCU. They still have a chance to go out and play Oklahoma State in Stillwater. So a lot of it is in front of them. And as it happens every year, teams are going to lose in front of you. If you keep winning, you're going to keep climbing. At the very least, if they were to win out, they're going to be in the discussion for sure.
Baylor, which came in with strengths of schedule issues, you would have to feel like this loss is going to knock them out of contention. They could potentially be a spoiler. Our Browns wouldn't like that label, but they go to Oklahoma State, which had to survive today in Ames. We're down to five unbeaten teams: Clemson, Ohio State, Oklahoma State, Iowa, and Houston now, which came back.
You and I have covered this Oklahoma team since 2000 many, many times, and we've seen them even win national championships. I don't know if I've ever seen a group of Oklahoma players and coaches so excited after a win than what we're witnessing right now. This obviously meant a lot to them, the opportunity and the challenge to come to Waco to take on this talented Baylor team.
Yep, the pent-up frustrations, the embarrassment of recent years, but also what it means for their season. The Oklahoma Sooners come as underdogs to Waco and knock off the Bears by 10, putting themselves very much in the playoff conversation. 44-34 is the final for Oklahoma here at McLean Stadium. Tonight's game was produced by Bill Bunnell, directed by Derek Mobley. For our entire crew, which braved the elements here in Waco, and for Kirk Herbstreit and Heather Cox, I'm Chris Fowler saying so long from Waco, where Mayfield and the Sooners are elated with themselves tonight, and why not? The Ford wrap-up show coming up right now as we kick it off to Cassidy Hubbard. Cassidy?